You read wrong. Eyes? That's all right. How you looking back that minute, baby? He clear. That's all I want to make sure. Got them pink and green eyes. Y'all ready? Let's do this thing. Let's try that again. What happened? Chill it. Stop. Thank you, kind sir, if you would. That's it. That's it. Everything happened for a reason. If I could, how it look back there? It's already messed up, but it don't look right, do it. We got to move some stuff around before we get started. All right, how we going to shift it around? Brandon Andre Sweat. I don't need all that complaining. How that look? Why it take you so long to get all that big?
Brandon went the short way. He didn't go the long
way. Brandon, go back and do it right, Brandon. Brandon.
Come on, man.
Go on, Brandon.
Go back where you had went. Oh.
Why y'all didn't tell me Brandon would cheat? What kind of monkey mess is that? Something still wrong up down. We need to switch again. Say chitlin in the middle. All right, what we gonna do? Before we move, let's make sure we need to check the chitlin meter. We have to find out where all the chitlin at. Good. Let's check the other side. So I need to move the chitlin around. Let's check the middle. All right, Brandon Chris, y'all know how to switch. Hold on, Prince, you can't cheat like that. Walk around. You got to walk around.
I've heard you teach before that the shortest distance between two places is a straight line.
Oh, that's and European you teaching.
You don't mean your own teacher.
All right, ladies, how that look all right? Let's do a chitlin check. Hold on, man. I think my needle missed. Let me try that thing one more time. Why am I leaving? Hold on a minute. What in the world? Good morning,
nigga.
Well, that's a lot of chilling on that side, ain't it?
Yeah, right.
We're going to try to work with this poke if we can. Y'all ready? All right, we good over now. All right, Maestro, if you with eyes. You probably been on standby when it fell. Well, though, we worry about your shit. Let's get ready to roll. Y'all ready? All right, we do always rise and give honor to the Most High, y'all. His son, Yeshua, the true Messiah. Always to all of y'all divine preachers in every place. Preaching, teaching, living, y'all's divine word. I always tell beloved ministers that labor with me in this part of the vineyard, whom I'm not ashamed to call brethren, Kaddish, greetings to them in their respective places. Always to those that are watching by way of live internet, to the dispersed, to the scattered, to the Jews first, and also to the Gentile, Kaddish, greeting to them in their respective places. As we ought to say last, never least, to the way of Yah Synagogue.
Amen.
Proper unto you all in your respective places.
Amen.
Once again, from TV, internet, radio, wherever our voice can be heard, wherever we can be seen. Before we came on, had nothing come on. When we go off, absolutely. Nothing else coming on.
Amen.
If they're not teaching Kaddish, living a clean, sanctified life, the people ain't in nothing, and they hadn't heard nothing. This is an attempt.
To collect the debt.
To collect the debt. Whatever you hypocrite, false pretend, backbite, mumbling, grumble against, will be used in that collection of a debt. These messages are always being recorded for quality assurance to make sure no side deal get cut with nobody. But everybody got to come in, Brother Red,
by the door.
Straight, narrow path. All right, 12th chapter of the book of Ecclesiastes, at verse 9. Amen. Thank the Lord for giving us one more day. He gave us the night of the day. We thank the Lord for the light of the day now. Isn't that right? That's why we're here. This is the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 12, at verse 9. Listen to the book.
And moreover. Because the preacher was wise.
What did he do?
He still taught the people knowledge.
He still taught the people knowledge. Listen.
Yea.
He did what?
He gave good heed.
He gave good heed.
And sought out
and set in order many proverbs.
We talked about that on last night, didn't we? That's why Isaiah told us we were going to be called what, brother?
Sought out.
And the book of Kings told us we were going to be what, brother? A proverb and a byword. So the king set out, the preacher sought out the lost, our people. That's what he told me he can't do, to seek and to save that which was lost. Isn't that right?
Amen.
So thank the Lord for allowing us to be him. Let me see some of the 10th chapter of the book of Matthew. Matthew chapter 10. Give me verse 5. Wonderful Savior.
Amen.
Listen to the book.
These 12 Jesus sent forth. And commanded them, saying,
do what?
Go not into the way of the Gentiles.
And in where?
Into any city of the Samaritans.
Into ye where?
Not.
Where you want to go to?
But go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
Other brother, jump on to that 2 Kings chapter 17. Might be 1 Kings I want. 1 Kings 17, 23. Make it first. Let me see. Is it 1 Kings 17, 23?
2 Kings.
2 Kings 17, 23. Listen to the book.
Until the Lord removed Israel out of his sight.
Bad map and make it verse 19. This is the 2 Kings chapter 17 at verse 19. Listen to the book.
Also Judah kept not the commandments of the Lord their God.
Y'all hear what happened? Judah also kept not the commandments of the Lord their God. Listen.
But walked in the statutes of Israel which they made. And the Lord rejected all the seed of Israel.
Y'all hear what the Lord did to Israel? He rejected them. Listen.
And afflicted them. And delivered them into the hand of spoilers.
And put them into the hands of people that plundered them. Listen.
Until he had cast them out of his sight. For he rent Israel from the house of David.
Y'all hear what he did? The Lord tore Israel from the house of David.
And they made Jeroboam the son of Nebat.
So this would have gave the Lord how many wives?
Two wives.
This would have gave him two. Listen.
And they made Jeroboam the son of Nebat king, and Jeroboam drave Israel from following the Lord.
Yes.
And made them sin a great sin. For the children of Israel walked in all the sins of Jeroboam.
Yeah.
Which he did.
Come on.
They departed not from them. Until the Lord removed Israel out of his sight.
What did he do?
As he had said by all his servants, the prophets.
Come on.
So was Israel carried away out of their own land to Assyria until this day.
They was carried away into Assyria out of their own land as it is this day. So we knew why he would have told the apostles not to go into the city of Samaria. Because Israel would not have been there. Israel was removed out of their own land, Samaria. The Jews, we were given where? Jerusalem, the city of peace. This was the land of Israel, Samaria, and they were driven out of their land because they disobeyed and did not follow, as did Judah. So what was going to happen to Judah?
Get kicked out too.
At the 17th chapter of the book of Jeremiah. Moreover, because the preacher was wise, he still taught the people knowledge. Yeah, he gave good heed. And sought out and set in order many proverbs. And that which was written was upright, even words of truth. The words of the wise are as golds. What do they do, brethren? They incite. They motivate. Listen. This is the 17th chapter of the book of Jeremiah. Give me about verse 19. Listen. Man. Jeremiah chapter 17 at verse 19. Listen.
Thus saith the Lord. Go and stand in the gate of the children of the people.
Y'all hear this? Go stand in the gate of the children of thy people.
Whereby the kings of Judah come in.
That was a different gate where the king came in at.
Amen.
Now he said where the kings of Judah come in. Listen.
And by which they go out. And in all the gates of Jerusalem.
Now you are standing on all the gates of Jerusalem.
And say unto them.
Yes. How many gates would have been in Jerusalem?
12.
12 gates. Jerusalem was just a prototype for the kingdom where we're going.
That's right.
They had 12 gates.
That's right.
The gate they came in, they were supposed to go out a different gate.
That's right.
There are 12 gates to the city where we look to go in our God's kingdom. That's how we recognize it.
Amen.
Jerusalem here is a prototype.
That's right.
Hold what you got. The 21st chapter of the book of Revelation at verse 1.
Amen.
What's the problem?
Amen.
We should know this.
Yes, sir.
Even Paul told her, how is it that which was natural then that which is spiritual?
Mm-hmm. That's right.
When we understand the premise of the prototype, then we should understand the very image when we see it.
That's right. That's right.
It made no sense to tell you something spiritual when you get carnal unless you had an understanding.
That's right.
That's why he gave you pastors according to his heart that'll feed you with knowledge and understanding.
Amen.
This is the 21st chapter of the book of Revelation at verse 1. Listen to the book.
And I saw a new heaven.
A new what?
Heaven.
And what else you saw?
And a new earth.
And what happened?
For the first heaven.
And the first what?
Earth.
Had did what?
Were passed away.
And what happened?
And there was no more sea.
And there was no more sea.
And I, John, saw the Kadesh city.
I saw the Kadesh city.
New Jerusalem.
Just like we find Christ, we find him being the new man. The Bible tells us that you might put on the new man, which is created after what? Righteousness and what else? After righteousness and what? True Kadesh. So now John saw new Jerusalem. Because the first one had passed away. The Lord going to remove all this. All these things Peter told her are kept in store by the same word. The word that created this is the same word that's keeping all this stuff in the store. For what day, brethren? Against the day of what? This is the day of perdition. The day of destruction. When the Lord come, he's going to destroy this place. He going to create a new heaven and a new earth. And there's going to be a new Jerusalem. So we learned it from the first premise. That's 21st chapter. Jump down. Let me see what about the 7th verse say. Listen.
He that overcometh shall inherit all things.
Yeah.
And I will be his God, and he shall be my son.
Yeah.
But the fearful and unbelieving and the abominable and murderers and whoremongers and sorcerers and idolaters and all liars shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone.
Yes.
Which is the second death.
Come on.
And there came unto me one of the seven angels, which had the seven vials full of the seven last plagues,
mm-hmm.
and talked with me, saying, come hither, I will shew thee the bride, the Lamb's wife.
Come on.
And he carried me away in the spirit to a great and high mountain, and he shewed me that great city, the Kadesh Jerusalem,
yeah.
descending out of heaven from God,
yeah.
having the glory of God,
yeah.
and her light was like unto a stone most precious,
yeah.
even like a jasper stone, clear as crystal,
yeah.
and had a wall great and high,
yeah.
and had 12 gates.
What was Nehemiah trying to restore?
Okay.
He was trying to put the wall back. The same thing for defense. The city got a wall too. Come on.
And had 12 gates.
How many?
12 gates.
Yes.
And at the gates, 12 angels.
And what happened?
And names written thereon.
Like what?
Which are the names of the 12 tribes of the children of Israel.
And why are those names written on that, brother?
You know where to go in.
So you know where to go in at. Ezekiel told us that. That's why the names are written on the wall. So we know exactly who go in at what gate. And the Gentiles that dwell among us, their inheritance is among whatever tribe they dwelt among.
That's
which
right.
means they would go in at that gate.
That's right.
Okay. Jump on back to the 17th chapter book of Jeremiah. This is the 17th chapter of the book of Jeremiah. Continuing at verse 19. Amen. Listen to the book.
Thus saith the Lord unto me.
Yeah.
Go and stand in the gate of the children of the people.
Yes.
Whereby the kings of Judah come in.
Get a fan back. Y'all done got another fan can put back down. I want the cameraman to burn up on me. Let it blow back down. Come on.
And by the which they go out.
Yes.
And in all the gates of Jerusalem.
Yes.
And say unto them.
Yes.
Hear ye the word of the Lord.
Come on.
Ye kings of Judah.
You kings of Judah.
And all Judah.
And all Judah.
And all the inhabitants of Jerusalem.
Yes.
That enter in by these gates.
Yes.
Thus saith the Lord.
Come on.
Take heed to yourselves.
Yes.
And bear no burden on the Sabbath day, nor bring it in by the gates of Jerusalem.
Y'all hear what he told them? He said you need to take heed to yourself that you bear no burdens on the Sabbath day, nor even bring it into the gates of Jerusalem. This important for us?
Amen.
It should be.
Amen.
Listen.
Neither carry forth a burden out of your houses on the Sabbath day.
Yes.
Neither do ye any work, but hallow ye the Sabbath day.
But hallow ye the Sabbath day.
As I commanded your fathers.
Just like I commanded your fathers.
But they obeyed not.
But they did not obey.
neither inclined their ear.
Neither did they incline their ear.
But made their neck stiff.
But they made their neck stiff, would mean they couldn't turn. Come on.
That they might not hear.
That they might not hear.
Nor receive instruction.
That they might not hear nor receive instruction.
And it shall come to pass.
Yeah.
If ye diligently hearken unto me.
Yeah.
Saith the Lord.
Yeah.
To bring in no burden through the gates of this city.
Yeah.
On the Sabbath day.
Uh-huh.
But hallow the Sabbath day.
But consecrate the Sabbath day.
To do no work therein.
Yeah.
Then shall there enter into the gates of this city.
Yeah.
Kings and princes sitting upon the throne of David.
Yeah.
Riding in chariots. And on horses.
Yeah.
They and their princes, the men of Judah.
Yeah.
And the inhabitants of Jerusalem.
Yeah.
And this city shall remain forever.
That's important for us. That's important for us.
Amen.
See, that was the 26th chapter of the book of Leviticus. Make it 26 and about 11. Wonderful Savior.
Yes, sir.
Chapter of the book of Leviticus at verse 11. Listen.
And I will set my tabernacle among you.
I will set my tabernacle among you.
And my soul shall not abhor you.
And my soul shall not hate you. Which means we got the Son. The Son was his tabernacle. He put him among us. Even the book of Revelation they tell that the tabernacle of God is with man. And he shall reign forever. Listen.
And I will walk among you.
I shall walk among you.
And will be your God.
And I will be your God.
And ye shall be my people.
And then when Thomas stuck his hand and thrust in his side, he said, my who?
My Lord.
And my who? He told him, I walk among you. Listen.
I am the Lord your God.
Turn him up a little bit. Come on.
Which brought you forth out of the land of Egypt.
Yeah, come on.
That ye should not be their bondmen.
Yeah.
And I have broken the bands of your yoke.
Yeah.
And made you go upright.
Come on.
But if ye will not hearken unto
that's
me.
That's amazing when the preacher sought out acceptable word, even words of truth. And that which was written was what now? If they obeyed it, he said, I'm going to make you walk upright. Where the preacher got it from? He gave good heed. He got it from the law.
That's right.
That's right. The king was supposed to keep him a copy of the law.
That's right.
That's why Jeremiah would have talked to the king. And all those that would have entered in at the gate. And let them know concerning the Sabbath. Because we were told something concerning the Sabbath. Listen.
But if he will not hearken unto me.
But if you won't listen to me.
And will not do all these commands.
And you won't do everything I command you to do.
And if you shall despise my statutes.
And if you despise my statutes.
Or if your soul abhor my judgment.
So if your soul abhor my judgment. That's what a lot of y'all do. Y'all got different faces and personality y'all show when you don't like what the Lord pronounced or tell you to do. Because God ain't going to talk to you himself. He's going to tell you by man. That's what the 13th chapter, 41st verse of the book of Acts taught to tell you. Behold, you despise the who?
One.
And you do what?
Amen.
For I work a work in your day, a work you shall in no wise believe, though a who? Amen. God, when they'll come down here and tell you. When the Lord come down here to speak to you, it's going to be for judgment. He told them in the book of Malachi, he said, I'm going to draw near to the source. So I'm going to be a swift witness against you when I come. Mm. When the Lord come back to speak to you, he's going to be in judgment.
Right.
So God let a man declare it to you and then tell you what y'all to do. But a lot of y'all sit around, you fight, you hate the judgment of God. You don't like it in your mind. You think it ain't God's judgment. It's my judgment. But my judgment is just all I do is tell you what God tell me to tell you.
That's right.
You don't want to hear it, but he ain't going to talk to you himself.
That's right.
Ain't that right? God done gave you instruction. You don't hear, you're not going to be saved.
That's right.
When you sure left him, how many of y'all think he come back here and talk to you? What makes sense he to pray the prayer? The 17th chapter. Pick me up, 17, 20. Actually, St. John. I teach a man or woman how to walk upright, but a lot of y'all won't hearken to it, but it's going to be to your own demise. A lot of y'all still try to rationalize, and I tell you something, you still see another way. And that's what Proverbs said, there's a way that seems right unto a man, but the end thereof ain't going to do nothing but kill you. How you going to fight me? Your fight ain't going to work against me. Even Moses tried to tell when they mumming and groaning against him. He said, who are me and Aaron that you should mum against us?
Right.
Your mumming not against us, your mumming against God.
That's right.
Isn't that right? God's going to declare that he know you ain't going to believe it. That's why he let a man tell it to you.
That's right. Amen.
You sit around praying, asking God to talk to you and speak to your heart. He's telling you now, you're an idiot.
That's right.
If God's going to speak to your heart, he's going to tell you what the book says. He's going to tell you nothing contrary to the word. Most of y'all already know you contrary. You know the word talking to you. You still sit around trying to rationalize. I think that's the man talking. The man talking to you. And you ain't listening. You won't heed to it, but you'll know when you wind up going to hell. Listen.
Neither pray I for these alone.
This is St. John chapter 17, verse 20. Neither pray I for these
alone.
Neither pray I for these
alone.
But for them also,
which shall believe on me,
through me telling them,
through their word.
These are praying to pray. How are you going to be saved if you don't hear their word? Tell me how you got saved. You didn't hear their word. For them that believe on me through their word. Through what they say about it. What we told you. A lot of people want to be saved. I don't know how you're going to do it. I just don't know how you're going to do it. You don't even follow simple instruction. When you're told not to do something, y'all always find a way to get around it anyway and rationalize some kind of way God's still working. God ain't working for you. You go contrary to his word. God working against you. Isn't that right? That's why we're looking at it's important that we're going back even looking at Leviticus. Why Jeremiah jump up here and start telling these people about the Sabbath day out of nowhere? What this got to do with anything? Come on down there, 26th chapter of the book of Leviticus. Give me about verse 33. Y'all all right today?
Amen.
Now I can help the nation.
Amen.
Y'all here trying to keep telling, they keep trying to run here trying to find all these books. The one they got, the one they found, they can't obey it.
That's right.
I've yet to find one of these failures pop up obey these 66.
That's right.
So let me see you go through and obey these.
That's right.
Here's some more. I know. Whole lot more out there, but get past this first.
Yep.
That man may say, you a math teacher, professor. I can't do basic math. I need to know algebra, trigonometry. Get that basic math first, then we'll start talking about that. Let's get past that 2 plus 2. Don't try to remember. Now, ain't no use to try to multiply when you can't add. It ain't going to make sense. You ain't going to do a make a man. You ain't going to learn a trick. It's not going to make sense. Listen to the book.
And I will scatter you among the heathen.
I'm going to scatter you among the heathens.
And will draw out a sword after you.
Listen, I'm going to draw out a sword after you. I don't know what this got to do with anything. Listen.
And your land shall be desolate.
And your land shall be desolate.
And your cities waste.
And your cities waste.
Then shall the land enjoy her Sabbaths.
Then shall the land do what?
Enjoy her Sabbaths.
Jeremiah talking about Sabbath. Go back all the way back to old dead Moses. Moses said, once I draw the sword out of you, then the land going to enjoy her Sabbaths. Listen.
As long as it lieth desolate.
What happened to it, son?
And ye be in your enemy's land.
And you be in your enemy's land.
Even then shall the land rest and enjoy her Sabbath.
Then the land going to enjoy her Sabbaths. That's important for us. We over here dealing with Jeremiah. That's what he's talking about. He made the 13th chapter of the book of Jeremiah.
Man.
Jeremiah 13, and give me about verse 20. That ain't what I want, but let's see what it says.
20.
Jeremiah 13 and 20. Listen.
Lift up your eyes.
Give him a little more volume. Lift up your what?
Eyes.
Lift up your eyes.
And behold them that come from the north.
Listen what he said. And look at them that come from the north.
Where is the flock that was given thee?
He said, where the flock that you had?
Thy beautiful flock.
Your beautiful flock.
What wilt thou say when he shall punish thee?
He said, what you going to say when he punish you?
For thou hast taught them to be captains.
Yeah.
And as chief over thee.
Yeah.
Shall not sorrows take thee as a woman in travail.
He said, shall not sorrow overtake you just like a woman in travail? Come on.
And if thou say in thine heart.
Yeah.
Wherefore come these things upon me?
Why in the world is happening to us?
For the greatness of thine iniquity.
Because of the greatness of your iniquity.
Are thy skirts discovered?
That's why your nakedness is being shown. Come on.
And thy heels made bare.
That's why you walk around barefooted.
Can
the skirt, he told him about it. He said, I'm going to uncover your buttocks.
That's right.
Look at our African brothers, so you'll find one in the way. Every time you see what you wind up seeing out on them. The butts always out, and they always barefoot, ain't they?
Yep.
I said, you know why? Because the iniquity of their fathers. Because of your transgression. The word come to pass for us. Listen.
Can the Ethiopian change his skin?
He talking about somebody black. Now, if they were white, why are they talking about Ethiopian? Can the Ethiopian change his skin?
Or the leopard his spots?
Can a leopard get rid of his spots?
Then may ye also do good that are accustomed to do evil.
You hear what he's saying? He said if the Ethiopian can turn white and the leopard can get rid of his spots, guess what? Then you can do right. Which will let you know these are two virtually impossible things to
That's
be done.
That's right.
Let me say three now. You doing right, a leopard get rid of his spot, and an Ethiopian turning white. These are virtually impossible to be done. He basically was being sarcastic.
Yeah.
He said, hey, an Ethiopian can turn white. A leopard can get rid of his spot. Then you who've been doing wrong, you can start doing right. Now, you know, they had to be sitting there saying, wow.
Yeah.
Wow. That's how prone you are to disobeying versus start to obey and follow. Listen.
Therefore, will I scatter them as the stubble that passes the way.
Listen, therefore shall I scatter them just like the stubble that passes the way.
By the wind of the wilderness.
By the wind of the wilderness. Now, listen. You know what's amazing about this? By the wind in the wilderness. Listen.
This is thy lot, the portion of thy measures for me.
You know what's amazing about that? Now, he's talking about scattering them in the wind. What did he say he's going to scatter them in the wind? Like what now?
Therefore will I scatter them as the stubble that passeth away by the wind of the wilderness.
By the wind of the wilderness. Let's pick up John and see what John said. St. John. Matthew, I'm sorry, chapter 3. Matthew chapter 3. Give me about verse 9. I don't want it, but we'll work down to it. It's all the same word, ain't it? You hold that Jeremiah chapter 13, verse 20, what I called it, I said I didn't want. Hold that for me. This is the book of Matthew, chapter 3, at verse 9. Listen to the book.
And think not to say within yourselves,
I have what?
We have Abraham to our father.
That's talking to us in him. Now, it's amazing John said it. Why would John say this? What revelation we can get from this? One apostle came along and clarified a little bit more of this. The reason why they can't say Abraham to their father. Who said it? Who? Peter. Who said it? Paul. What did Paul say? Who? That talked about the children that are of the flesh. These are not the seed of Abraham. So when John would have told him this, now this would have been offensive to a Jew. You don't tell a Jew Abraham not his father. So Paul came along. He gave us some clarification. He let us know that his kinsmen according to the flesh. He was talking concerning natural, carnal. I wish that myself were a curse for Christ for them. Concerning the promise. Concerning the reason why Christ came. And the giving of the law to them. Then he went to talk about Abraham and how the children that are of the flesh, these are not the children of Abraham. The only reason we can bear record of that, because we can find other kids that were cast out of from the flesh. Ishmael, Jackson, Medan, Jackson. All of them were cast out, and they were of the what? They were of the flesh. They were not of the promise. So understanding this is not hard for Jews. This is not the first time we've heard that. Because you won't ever find an inheritance to these other sons, will you? Because they were of the flesh. They were not of the promise. The promise came through by the righteousness of faith, which would be something that brings a spiritual attribute. They came through by the flesh.
Right.
Make sense?
Right.
So hearing that you're saying that you're Abraham's seed and not having and not being an heir according to the promise is not hard for Jews, for Israelites to understand. Because we've seen others that were cut off. Hold you got 25th chapter of the book of Genesis. Let's make sure we get understanding.
Amen.
Unlike a lot of them, you know you worthy of death, you don't have understanding.
That right.
That's why I look at you guys with a man that y'all can come here and go to sleep. And you don't understand. Because now you're going to wind up dying. You're going to hell. You are a candidate to go to hell if you don't understand. Now, when you make a statement and tell me the children these are that are of the flesh are not the children of Abraham, I need to understand. I can't say, what it mean? What it say? What it said? That's what it meant. That's not understanding. Then I'm just reciting. We have to understand that. I had to be able to find some basis, some premises. Other brother, give me Genesis chapter 21 at verse 8. Hold that for me. This man, I told him, think not to say you got Abraham to your father. What did this mean to a Jew? Versus, I mean, that mean Abraham ain't your father. According to what? Because John said it? Because John said it? This is the problem we have. The average of our belief is by the precept of men.
Yep.
It's not biblical.
Yep.
It's not fundamentally found according to God's word. It's just based off, that's what I was told. This is the book, 25th chapter of the book of Genesis, verse 1.
Amen.
Listen.
Then again, Abraham took a wife.
Turn it up. Listen, when I said in the apostolic church, none of them ever taught me Abraham had another wife. They'll make a move and make Abraham and just have him and Sarah. Mm-hmm. Had God pop in and gone. They'll never talk about Keturah. Because they're too stupid. Oh, they ain't got nothing to do with nothing to keep going. We need to know about it.
That's right.
Then again, Abraham took a wife named Keturah. What happened, son?
And she bare him Zimran.
Zimran.
And Jokshan.
Jokshan.
And Medan.
Medan.
And Midian.
The Midianites. All these four. We know them. Huh?
That's right.
Jephthah was a Midianite.
That's right.
Abraham's father, Moses' father-in-law. You should know this.
That's right.
He tried to tell him when he wanted him to be iron for him when they came out of the wilderness.
Yep.
He told his father-in-law, don't go back over there.
Right.
He said, stay with us. He said, you be eyes for us as we go through. You know the way through because y'all been scattered.
That's right.
We're not used to being dispersed out nowhere.
That's right.
When we came out of Egypt, we were used to being in one or two places. We were in our own land or we were in Egypt.
Yep.
We didn't know nothing about no wilderness.
That's right.
He came in front of our Jehovah. He told you be eyes for us.
Yep.
And said, it'll come to pass that whatsoever good God do to us, it'll fall on you.
That's right.
But like most idiots, they go back to their own people.
Yep.
Listen.
And Ishbak. And Shua. And Jokshan begot Sheba.
Yeah.
And Dedan.
Yeah.
And the sons of Dedan were Ashuram.
Uh-huh.
And Letheshim.
Come on.
And Luimim.
What verse you at now?
At verse 4.
Jump down and give me verse 5, verse 6. Listen.
But unto the sons of the
covenant. Give me verse 5. Come on, son.
And Abraham gave all that he had unto Isaac.
And Abraham, hold you got 21, verse 8, Genesis. We're going to come back.
Amen.
Listen.
And the child grew.
And the child grew.
And was weaned.
And he was weaned.
And Abraham made a great feast the same day.
Listen.
That Isaac was weaned.
And what happened?
And Sarah saw the son of Hagar the Egyptian.
Yeah.
Which she had borne unto Abraham.
Listen.
Mocking. Wherefore she said unto Abraham, cast out this bondwoman.
And her who?
Her son.
Come on.
For the son of this bondwoman shall not be heir with my son.
Even who?
With Isaac.
What verse you at?
Verse 11.
Give me verse 12.
Amen.
Come on.
And God said unto Abraham,
do what?
Let it not be grievous in thy sight.
Let it not be what?
Grievous in thy sight.
All that what?
Because of the lad.
Because of the lad.
And because of the bondwoman.
What happened, son?
And all that Sarah hath said unto thee.
Yeah.
Hearken unto her voice.
Hold on. Read that again, that verse 12. Hold on, brother. You pick me up at St. John chapter 8 at verse 30. Let's see what's going on here.
Amen.
This is what he told right here. This is Genesis 21, 12. Other brother got me St. John chapter 8, verse 30. Other brother still hold me the 25th chapter of the book of Genesis at verse 5. Y'all all right?
Amen.
Boy, if I was a preacher, I could remember this stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I just can't hold this stuff in my head for nothing. Listen.
And God said unto Abraham,
yeah?
Let it not be grievous in thy sight.
What happened?
Because of the lad and because of thy bondman.
And God said unto Abraham, let it not be what?
Grievous in thy sight.
Because of the lad?
And because of thy bondwoman.
Because of the lad?
And because of thy bondwoman.
At St. John chapter 8 at verse 30. We'll come back over there to Genesis chapter 21 and verse 12. This is St. John 8 and 30. Listen to the book.
As he spake these words.
Many did what?
Believed on him.
Who is many? How many? Many. A lot. What nationality is many?
It don't say.
We know. But they press. Somebody said, what nationality is many? What you going to actually tell them? It don't say. What did it say after that?
Then said Jesus to those Jews.
So I know one thing who he was talking to. At that point, he was talking to the Jews. I don't care what else were out there. I don't care. Medan, Jokshan, I don't know, Zimram, who else out there? Jesus started talking to the Jews.
That's right.
Then said Jesus to those who?
Jews.
That did what?
Believed on him.
So you ain't believe. I wouldn't even talk to you anyway.
That's right.
I hope you ain't talking to me because I don't believe. Good, because I ain't talking to you.
That's right.
I'm talking to those Jews that believe on me.
Yes, sir.
Listen.
If ye continue in my word,
then
are ye my disciples indeed.
And
ye
shall know the what?
Truth.
And the truth
shall make you free.
Listen what he said.
They answered him. We be Abraham's seed.
And were never what?
In bondage to any man.
We didn't come from Hagar.
Man.
He just told Abraham, don't let the thing grieve you because of the lad and the who?
And because of thy bondwoman.
She's been a slave. He asked about Israel before he had Israel homeborn slave.
That's right.
They were trying to let him know, we didn't come from no Ishmael. They said, we be Abraham's seed.
Yeah.
And we were never in bondage to any man. We didn't come from no bondwoman. Genesis 21.
Amen.
Verse 12. Other brothers still hold me. Genesis 25, verse 5.
Amen.
Listen to the book.
And God said unto Abraham.
What he told Abraham?
Let it not be grievous in thy sight.
Because of the who?
Of the lad.
And because of who?
Of thy bondwoman. And all that Sarah has said unto thee.
Don't listen to her, tell her, shut her mouth.
Hearken unto her voice.
Listen. For what reason?
For in Isaac
shall thy seed be called.
That's the promise. That's the promise. So we hear that they that are of the flesh are not the seed of Abraham. This ain't hard. Those were children of Abraham by the flesh. This was the only way given to him at a promise. How we know it's at a promise? Because it was already said. And he picked me up in the ninth chapter of the book of St. John, ninth chapter of the book of Romans, 9 and 1. Everybody put on, Paul either going to be gay, woman hater, hypocrite, by these lying hypocrite. Yeah. Isn't that right? I don't know why so many people got a problem. I ain't got a problem with not one right in the book.
That's right.
Now, one writing book I got a problem with. I love them all. And got to go along with what they said, I can't even be saved.
That's right.
I can't pick and choose which one I like. He told Tim to do these things. What he told him to do, brother? Without what? Preferred. Don't start liking. You start liking one more than other, you're going to favor one more than other.
Yep.
He said, you do these things without preferred, because you're going to wind up messing. That's what mess up a whole lot of Hebrew Israelites.
Mm-hmm.
They prefer the Old Testament because they can justify them with the women.
Yep.
If they can come along, they can try to get by. When you come to the apostle come along and give you understanding on some things.
Yes, sir.
They don't like it.
That's right.
I just prefer the Old Testament.
Uh-huh.
I don't like Greek. I don't like Greek either.
That's right.
But though they're Catholic, you're on the Catholic, what language you going to speak?
The language of the Catholic.
Nehemiah, in the 13th chapter of the book of Nehemiah, he went by and started pronouncing curses on our people and snapped them. Why?
They couldn't speak Hebrew.
Because they spake in the language of their captor and not in the Hebrew language.
That's right.
What language would you think we're going to speak with selling our captives? Ain't nothing new.
That's right.
Why Paul gonna say he pull a sign or he gonna put Hebrew, Latin, and Greek?
Yep.
Because all the Hebrews did not speak Greek, did not speak Hebrew.
That's right.
Some would have spoken Latin and some would have spoken Greek.
Yep.
Let these people make no fool out of you.
Mm-hmm.
I don't like it because it ain't Greek. And they'll come on here in America and cuss up and use every American word they can find.
Yep.
Oh, lying nigga.
Yep.
That's right.
Sick of them.
Yep.
I'm trying to make an excuse for not obeying. Me not speaking, he ain't no excuse not to obey no book.
That's right.
And you speaking ain't no excuse for you to not obey it.
That's right.
Someone tell me you can't obey, can't keep the Kadish day because you not in your land. Where you going to get that lie from?
Mm.
Paul sat there and he kept Pentecostal up and not in Jerusalem.
Yep.
He said because an effectual door was opened up to him.
Yep.
Let's see what he said. 1 Corinthians chapter 16, right quick, son.
Amen.
1 Corinthians chapter 16.
Yes, sir.
Drop down and give me verse 6.
Amen.
Hey, folks, get on my darn nerve. Everybody come up with something different. One folks just start looking at how to obey. First thing they need to pray or get a clean life.
Amen.
Let me hear you talk without cursing.
Yeah.
Let me see you stop lusting and fornicating, committing adultery.
Yes, sir. That's right.
You know, doing cross dressing.
Yeah.
Isn't that right?
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Oh, sit right here, man. We so contrary, it's ridiculous. Listen to the book.
And it may be that I will abide, yea, and winter with you, that ye may bring me on your journey, whithersoever
what
I
go. What verse you at? Verse 6?
Yes, sir.
Come on.
For I will not see you now, but by the way.
Come on.
But I trust to tarry a while with you.
Yeah.
For the Lord permit.
Come on.
But I would tarry at Ephesus until Pentecost.
I would tarry where?
At Ephesus. Until Pentecost.
I would tell that Ephesus to when?
Pentecost.
Why are you going to be there?
For a great door and effectual is open unto me.
You tell me Ephesus was in Jerusalem? Why are he going to stay there at the Pentecost? It's a door been open. That's why we here. A door open.
That's right.
To get these Gentiles and bring some of our people out. We going back home.
That's right.
Make no mistake. The Most High God going to take us out of the land of captivity. We going back to Jerusalem. Y'all hear me? We going back home. He going to bring us out like he brought us out before.
Yes, sir.
Our God going to deliver us. It's some more eyes got to come open here.
That's right.
And are we ready to go back now? No, we go there. Every one of our people that went back over there, they wind up adapting and find them fake Jewish
you're right.
people.
You right. Yeah.
Come in and try to shove a pocket for my darn face. Shut your mouth, stupid
right.
nigga.
That's right.
They tell you what they wouldn't do what they slave master do.
Yep.
Just like we around here, we were good Christian.
Yep.
One slave learned and go teach it to the other slaves.
Yep.
Now all of us sit here buying the same premise.
Yeah.
Pledge allegiance to a flag ain't never did nothing for you.
Yep.
Got you talking about being emancipated. You better with some darn tomato paste. Made fools out of us.
Amen.
And so we run and we start fighting our doing captives again. Everything they learned from our people according to 2 Kings 17 chapter.
Yep.
When they took our land, they didn't know. They didn't know the custom of the land.
That's right.
They took our priests and learned the custom.
That's right.
Now we sit around and got to watch them to learn what we need to do. They're our oppressors.
That's right.
All right, Mordecai. I got different laws.
Yeah.
My law more diverse than their law.
Yes, sir.
I don't buy into their hype.
Amen.
People of God got to have something different. They're going to cost us our life, but we're standing on it.
Yes, amen. Sir.
Y'all hear me?
Amen.
We talked before. All the stuff these people got us out here doing, these folks ain't obeying nothing. Mm-mm. I'm not moved with all these other books people saying they found. They ain't obeying these books.
That's right.
Isn't that right? What, that 2 Samuel again, 118? You can drop that 21st chapter of the book of Genesis. Still home in that 24 and 5. St. John 8, 32, 33, you can let it go. Wonderful Savior.
Amen.
Other brother, you get me 1 Chronicles 29 and 1.
Amen.
This 2 Samuel chapter 1 at verse 18. Make it 17. Other brother got me 1 Chronicles chapter 29 and verse 1. That'd be fine for now. Other brother, you jump over and see that 2 Chronicles chapter 12. I hold me about verse 13. Wonderful Savior. That's why we're here.
Amen. Yes, sir.
Boy, if I was a preacher, I'd be able to just call stuff. I'd be able to call like scripture, pistol up like that. If you ain't a preacher, you can't do it. Listen to the book.
And David lamented with this lamentation.
And David started crying with his lamentation.
Over Saul and over Jonathan, his son.
Over Saul and over Jonathan, his son.
Also, he bade them teach the children of Judah the use of the bow.
He taught them how to use the bow. Where was it written, that son?
Behold, it is written in the book of Jasher.
Pick me up at 1 Chronicles 29 and 1.
Amen.
Other boy got me 2 Kings chapter 12. Hold me about verse 13. It's all the same word, ain't it? Listen to the book.
Furthermore, David the king said unto all the congregation. Solomon, my son, whom alone God has chosen.
Y'all hear this? Psalm alone, my son, whom God has chosen.
Is yet young and tender. And the work is great. For the palace is not for man.
Yeah.
But for the Lord God.
Y'all hear that? The palace is not for man. It's for the Lord God. Talk to me, son.
Now I have prepared with all my might.
To do what?
For the house of my God.
Listen.
The gold for things that be made of gold.
Yeah.
And the silver for things of silver.
Yeah.
And the brass for things of brass.
Yeah.
The iron for things of iron.
Yeah.
And wood for things of wood.
Yeah.
Onyx stones. And stones to be
saved. Where we heard onyx stones at before?
Revelation.
David made preparation for the house of our God.
Amen.
The things for stone, the thing to gate, the thing for metal, the thing for wood. Listen.
Glistering stone. And of diverse colors.
And they had topaz.
Amen.
David's already prepared this stuff.
Yes, sir.
David was a man after God's own heart.
Yes, sir.
Listen.
And all manner of precious stone.
And marble stone.
In abundance.
Moreover, because of what, David?
I have set my affection.
To where?
The house of my God.
That means I set my affection
yes,
to it.
Yes, sir.
Y'all been taught, now you the house of God.
Amen.
See, now you got to learn this same premise. Not going and adorning yourself with these decorative things on the outside, but adorning yourself with the hidden man of the heart.
Yes, sir.
See, David set up a premise for it when it come down to the natural time. He said, I set my heart. If that's for God, why would I set my best for it? Why would I try to purpose to go beyond? Who are we taught from the female standard that went beyond? The virtuous woman.
That's right.
Excelleth them all.
Yes, sir.
David said, moreover, because I set my affection toward the house of God. Now, you've been taught that through the house of God, where is your affection?
Yes, sir.
Should be on things above and not on things on the earth.
Yes, amen. Sir.
You're supposed to be dead and your life's supposed to be hid in Christ and God.
Amen.
Listen.
I have of mine own proper good.
Did what, son?
Of gold and silver.
Did what?
Which I have given to the house of my God.
Do what?
Over and above all that I have prepared.
Excelleth them all. God said, a president, why would I want to try to do that and even go beyond? I told y'all before about the scant measure, which is what, brother? Barely sufficient. When you start just trying to meet the little light, you barely, man, ain't nothing bad about you barely skating it.
Yeah.
They said, moreover, I said abundant to do more than that. Why are we talking about all this? Get down to the 27th verse.
Amen.
That's not what I want, but let's see what it say. Listen to the book.
And the time that he reigned over Israel.
And the time he reigned over Israel
was 40 years.
40 years.
7 years reigned he in Hebron.
Yeah.
And 33 years reigned he in Jerusalem. And he died.
You know, it's amazing. That's what Jesus did. He went out over approximately 33 years.
That's right. That's right.
7 years he reigned in Hebron, which would have put him with who, brethren? Would put him over Judah.
Judah. That's right.
He'd been king over Judah before he was king over Israel.
That's right.
We would need to know that.
Amen.
Listen.
And he died in a good old age.
He died in a good old age. Tell me something else about it.
Full of days.
Full of days.
Riches and honor.
Tell me something else about it.
Solomon, his son, reigned in his stead.
Tell me something else about it.
Now the acts of David.
Now the acts of David.
First and last.
His first and last.
Behold, they are written.
Where they written at?
In the book of Samuel, the seer. And in the book of Nathan, the prophet.
And in the book of Nathan, the prophet. Where else?
And in the book of Gad, the seer.
We got Samuel.
Yes, sir.
Samuel already done declared it to him.
That's right.
That's what we see in your reading.
Yep.
Let's see what he told him. Pick me up at 2 Samuel. What's the last chapter? 25. Y'all help me out. Y'all know ain't no preacher. What's the last one? 21? 24? Let me see what 24 and 1, 23 and 1 say. Listen to the book.
Now these be the last words of David.
Now, Dee, what book are we reading?
2 Samuel.
What book are we reading?
Samuel.
Well, he already telling us about it. Now, Dee be the last words of David. Talk to me, Samuel.
David, the son of Jesse, said,
yeah?
And the man who is raised up on high, the anointed of the God of Jacob.
Talk to me, son. That will make him the who? Savior. The anointed of the God of Jacob?
Savior.
That would make him Messiah.
That's right.
Hold what you got. Book of Psalms, 2nd chapter.
Amen.
They'll call it division, and they don't realize they the one divided, stupid yep. self. Don't go to hell for calling Psalm no chapter. Stupid self, you got it numbered out like chapters.
Yeah.
Psalm, the 2nd chapter. Listen.
Why do the heathen rage?
Why did the heathen rage? And then what else?
People imagine a vain thing.
What happened, son?
The kings of the earth set themselves. And the rulers take counsel together.
Oh, what happened, son?
Against the Lord.
Against the who?
The Lord.
Against the who?
Lord.
Against the who?
Lord.
And who else?
Against his anointed.
I don't even know what they mean. At the 23rd chapter, 2 Samuel, verse 1. Listen to the book.
Now these be the last words of David.
These be the last words of David.
David, the son of Jesse, said.
Yeah.
And the man who was raised up on high,
yeah.
The anointed of the God of Jacob, and the sweet psalmist of Israel, said,
yeah.
The Spirit of the Lord spake by me,
yeah.
And his word was in my tongue.
And his word was in my tongue.
The God of Israel said,
hold you, God. Let me see what happened over here at the 22nd chapter of the book of Matthew. Matthew 22, see about verse 40. Wonderful Savior. Listen to the book.
On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets.
Come on, son.
While the Pharisees were gathered together,
yeah.
Jesus asked them.
What did he ask?
Saying, what think ye of Christ?
Yeah.
Whose son is he?
And what did they say?
They say unto him.
The who?
The son of David.
The son of David. What happened, son?
He saith unto them.
What did he tell them?
How then does David in spirit call him Lord?
How did David what now?
In spirit call him Lord.
How did David how now?
In spirit.
In what?
Spirit, call him Lord.
Pick me up again. You hold what you got. Pick me back up at 23 and verse 2. That we left off at?
Amen.
Let's see what happened. Listen.
The Spirit of the Lord spake by me, and his word was in my tongue.
So how did David speak it?
By the Spirit.
What did David say?
The God of Israel said.
The God of Israel said.
The Rock of Israel spake to me.
The Rock of Israel spake to me.
He that ruleth over men.
Must be what?
Just.
That's right. Yes, sir.
David already seen the anointed going up and knew he was the anointed.
That's right.
That's why he sat down, he asked him about the son by Christ. He wanted to know whose son. They told him he's the son of David. Hmm. He wanted to know how David said in the spirit. He already testified and let them know David spake about the Spirit. That's what he tried to tell Peter when he asked, he said, but whom do you say that I, the Son of Man, am? He said, thou art the who now?
Son.
The Son of the who?
Living God.
And he blessed him. For who didn't reveal it to him, brother?
Wow.
Flesh and blood did not reveal it, but the Spirit. That's why he asked how did David in the Spirit say, you couldn't say to yourself. The Spirit had to give it to him. That's important for us to know. People trying to go find all the other. You can go find Gad. You can go find the book of Nathan. When you get through them seals, you come right back here. He already told you, Samuel recorded it too.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. Samuel already got a record. Said, these be the last words of David. Huh? When David spake that, he would get ready to leave. Pick up that 2 Kings. 2 Chronicles chapter 12. Is that what I call 2 Chronicles chapter 12, verse 15? I said 1 Chronicles? No, I didn't say 1 Chronicles. You write it down and you can't get it right. So that 2 Chronicles chapter 12 is what I want. Verse 15, make it verse 13. Listen.
So King Rehoboam strengthened himself in Jerusalem.
Come on, Tony. King Rehoboam. What now? King who?
Rehoboam.
Who was that?
Solomon's son.
That's right, Solomon's son. Y'all do that right. Y'all didn't know that? Oh, y'all ain't got that far yet. That's Solomon's son. He said it covered that right. That's Rehoboam. You need to know that. That's Solomon's son. This is the son that got it when the kingdom got divided. Then Jehoboam, he took over Israel. Isn't that right? They broke off. They said they had no part in David. They separated themselves. Only Benjamin stayed. Y'all need to know that. This came into the conforming of Yehuda. Isn't that right? They broke off. They stayed there. Judah and Benjamin stayed. Jehoboam let them know, we ain't got no part of them. They went to Jehoboam, they were going to stay. They just said, make our burden lighter. They said, your father, he chastised him. He went and he consulted with the young men. The old men told him, hearken to him, but the young men told him, no. He said, I'm going to chastise. He said, my father chastised y'all with whips. I'm going to beat your behind with scorpions. Said, my little finger going to be thicker than my father's whole waist. He was letting them know, we ain't going to be able to take a whole lot. We gone. We out of here. We ain't got no part in Judah. We gone. Isn't that right?
Yep.
We're going to fight against, but the Lord came and told us, don't fight against your brother.
That's right.
This thing is of God. He told us, don't you fight against. We're going to go up and defeat him. Yehuda used to fight.
Yeah.
Caleb, when our great-grandfather, they came down here to get his inheritance. He was 80 years old.
That's right.
He told him, he made the man Joshua let him know, the man Moses, when he lived, he swore he was going to give it unto me.
Yeah.
So he dead, said 40 years old when he told me he was going to give it to me. So I'm this day 80 years old.
Yes, sir.
So I'm stronger this day than I was at 40, to go in and to go out. And if the Lord be with me, I'd be well able to go and drive him out.
That's right.
Caleb took Hebron.
Yes, sir.
That's why David would have came and he'd have set king in Hebron.
That's right.
We'd be well able to take it. Amen. That's why he had no fear about no Goliath.
That's right.
We Yehuda, we used to fight.
Amen. Mm-hmm.
Y'all all right?
Amen.
We've been fighting our life since we got him.
That's right. Amen. That's right.
Can't no doing picket sign for these people.
Come on.
That's why he told Tim to fight the good fight of what?
Amen.
But make sure you clarify, we're going to knock a nigga out.
That's right.
We that's Mike Tyson, and he ain't putting no faith in that. We like, let's start scrapping.
Yeah.
How we going to fight?
Yep.
Start throwing something in that right.
That's right.
But we know our weapon not carnal, and they mighty through God.
That's right.
That was a lot of Hebrew. They like, I like my brother. My brother about to start telling you, I ain't your brother, nigga. I ain't finna take up nothing until I killing nobody. Yeah,
that's right. Right.
Kill him with kindness. Yeah. I'm going to kill him with understanding. Isn't that right? I'm going to kill him with not conforming to their foolishness.
That's right.
Listen to the book.
And reigned. For Rehoboam was 140 years old when he began to reign, and he reigned 17 years in Jerusalem.
Yeah.
The city which the Lord had chosen out of all the tribes of Israel to put his name there.
Yeah.
And his mother's name was Naamah.
Uh-huh.
And Ammonitess. And he did evil because he prepared not his heart to seek the Lord.
Yeah.
Now the acts of Rehoboam, first and last.
The acts of Rehoboam?
First and last.
The acts of Rehoboam?
First and last.
Where they at, son?
Are they not written in the book of Shemaiah, the prophet?
So we know it's on the book. They got it. They got Shemaiah in the apocrypha? They ain't got that in there either, do they? They ain't got that in there either. They ain't looking for a Shemaiah book.
Nope.
What does he tell? The book of Nathan not in there either.
Nope.
They got everybody else's book other than what he tell them, though.
That's right.
See, that's why I tell you, I'm more fast than coming out of these people. I'm going to tell you something. These folks don't move me with all these books they got. I said, put them up there. Somebody put up there. The Apocrypha is not inspired by y'all. I don't want that name up there. I don't try to get people to do, let's sit down and let's see. Let's sit down and watch to see. If information come to prove it valid, I got no problem with conforming.
Yeah.
But right now, you're stuck like a hoax.
Yeah.
Right now, it's going to be hard to prove what you got.
Yeah.
Back to that 13th chapter of the book of Jeremiah. Let's see why we went here.
Man.
I remember, is that what I called before 13th chapter of the book of Jeremiah? Y'all hear Malcolm? I can't remember that well. I think I called verse 20. I ain't sure because I ain't a preacher. Does that sound like it could probably be remotely right?
Amen.
Some kind of way right? I said it was the reason why I called 20 because that wasn't what I want, is it? Because y'all remember we read in the 13th chapter, we were reading about him talking about he's going to stubble them and scatter them as the wind. We didn't finish up in the third chapter, if you would, in the third chapter of the book of Matthew. You remember that? We were telling him at the third chapter, at verse 9, when he told you don't think to say you had Abraham to your father. And hold the 13th chapter of the book of Jeremiah, verse 20. We had read down, we hit that earlier. But I was a preacher, I don't remember that. This is 3 and 9.
Amen.
Listen.
And think not to say within yourselves,
we have who?
Abraham to our father.
What is God able to do?
For I say unto you that God is able of these stones to raise up children unto Abraham.
Listen.
And now also the axe is laid unto the root of the tree.
Yeah.
Therefore, every tree which bringeth not forth good fruit
is what?
Hewn down.
Talk to me, son.
And cast into the fire.
Talk to me.
I indeed baptize you with water.
But what happened to what's
repentance? But he that cometh after me
is mightier than who?
Than I.
I don't know what you could tell me next.
Whose shoes I am not worthy to bear.
Talk to me. What else he got?
He shall baptize you with the Ruach HaKodesh.
And with what?
Fire.
Listen.
Whose fan is in his hand.
We just got through reading the 13th chapter. He's talking about how the wind was going to scatter them.
That's right.
See, if you're not a Jew and you don't know the law, this wouldn't make any sense to you. In the 13th chapter book of Jeremiah, he just told you what he's going to do. I'm going to scatter you. John said his fan is in his hand. His winnowing fan is in his hand.
Yeah.
He's going to scatter you. Wow.
Yes,
what did this have to do with anything? This is why we have so much ignorance among our people, because they don't know.
Yeah.
Why would he be talking to Jews about a fan?
Scatter.
Because they already been told in the 13th chapter. The man just told them how the wind was going to scatter them. That ain't the first time they've seen the wind. They have. Think of the 5th chapter of the book of Ezekiel, verse 1.
Man.
You trying to think of what it said before you get there? That's pretty smart. Did you know?
Yeah.
What did it say? Close it up. Don't tell me what it talk about. Quote it word for word. Exactly. I'm messing with you. 5th chapter of the book of Ezekiel, verse 1. He still got me that Genesis chapter 25 and verse 5, if I can remember that. I probably can't remember it, though. Listen to the book.
And thou, son of man, take thee a sharp knife.
And do what?
Take thee a barber's razor, and cause it to pass upon thine head and upon thy beard.
Yeah.
And take thee balances to weigh.
Take you balances to weigh.
And divide the hair.
And where we find out about scales at? The law told us about. What the law told us?
Just weigh.
Just measure. And we learned the book of Revelation. When he saw the horse, he said he had a scale of balances. That's what, even, you know, it's amazing how these hypocrites that now to take God out. You go look at their courtroom, they got balance scales up there. Supposed to be for justice. They got it from us. They hypocrites.
Yep.
Right.
See, a hypocrite that came in like they were serving God. They said all the premises. Judge, yep. Come all right. They got it from Daniel.
Yep.
They didn't say, seen the ancient of days, his hair was white. They go get a white wig.
Yep.
Walk in court with a black robe on, all rise.
Yep.
Then when he sat down, then when he said the ancient of days came, said, then the courts were set,
yep,
for judgment. Then it's set for judgment. These hypocrites stole everything from us.
That's right.
They claim they were law-abiding. They claim they were following God. Now they say, well, you can't use God. People offended. Well, you can't use the book. We don't want to get the Bible out of it. Truth be told, the Bible was never in it, neither was God.
That's right.
Took prayer out of school, everybody, because they ain't never had it.
Yeah.
If you had it, nobody could take it away from you.
That's right.
Jesus said, those that Father given me, said, no man able to take them out of my hand. So my Father is greater than all. And nobody can take them out of my Father's hand. Hey, people ain't never hypocrites.
That's right.
Like you go to court and sing, and then what makes it so bad, they sing and they put a jury on your peers. Then Paul comes on and say, the saints going to judge the who?
Word. Yep.
Man, these people so dumb, and then these ignorant people sit here and follow these retards. Your whole hope and understanding in these retards.
Yep.
Stole everything they got from the book, then they come along and denounce God. God ain't worried about it. He know he never had me in the first place. And the same thing with a whole lot of Hebrew, Israelite, and Jewish, bro. Most ain't never hypocrites.
Yeah, amen. That's right.
Gentiles came along and provoked us to jealousy.
Yep.
That was the purpose of letting me provoke you to jealousy. Let you see another people God let come in and they'll obey.
That's right.
Paul told you clearly in the 28th chapter of the book of Genesis at verse, in the 28th chapter of the book of Acts at verse 28. Be it known unto you that the salvation of God had gone into the Gentiles and that they will do what, brethren? Yeah. They going to hear it.
Yes, sir.
The Jew done say, you'll stop your ears up.
Yep.
Keep being stupid and sleeping. God got a Gentile that's going to stay awake.
Yep.
God got somebody going to come and obey what he told him to do. Mm-hmm. They keep on being stupid thinking you got a part. Try to tell you, you are the flesh. You're not no children of Abraham.
That's right.
You go ahead and keep claiming Abraham. God don't need you to claim Abraham. It's going to be a promise. The ninth chapter I told him to get me in the book of Romans, he told you clearly with promise. He said, at that time, I will come back and she's going to bear a son. That was a promise.
That's right. That's right.
You know what this is? Thank you, Leon. Leon said, hey, bail me out of that. I'm going to promise it. No. I give you this. This is supposed to be guaranteed. I'm going to bring you the gold equivalent to what their paper say. That's a promise. That's what God gave Abraham. That's why the other children that came from Abraham is nowhere in the world they had no cover. God didn't promise them nothing.
Yeah, that's right.
They didn't come by promise. Even he, what God gave him because he saw it greed. And God didn't promise that before he got here. There was no promise. He said, because of your son, I'll also make him a great nation too. He'll get prince. But out of Isaac, king's going to reign.
Yeah.
Everybody know a king got to rank a prince.
That's right.
Bow down, nigga. Show enough.
That's right.
He's the master.
That's
show
right.
Show enough.
That's right.
Oh, good dog. Why these folks can't say here you're a girl? You can't get no prince to outrank no king. Man, standing on the wall. Listen to the book.
Thou shalt burn with fire a third part in the midst of the city.
Now, how you going to know a third part without having a scale to balance it? To weigh it out. We're talking about hell. See, you know why he had to do this? Because you got to use the law to make sure you do it right. You let people jump. You know why he would use a scale? Because Jesus told some in the seventh chapter of the book of St. John. What was it, brother? Judge not according to the what? Appearance. If I say here, look at it, it'll look like it's the same thing. But if I weigh it, scale don't lie.
Yeah.
Numbers just don't lie. You can't manipulate numbers. You can manipulate words. You can argue on and on about pronunciation of a word. Can you not?
Yeah.
But it comes down to numbers. You can't manipulate it what it is.
That's right.
So he told him to use the scale. That's why you sure can. He told him, don't judge according to appearance. I judge what?
Right.
I'm going to judge right. I got to judge according to the law.
That's right.
The law's the one that came along to a just weight, just hear, and just measure. I got to use a scale.
Amen.
Isn't that right? You can tell. I tell you that you can lay me on 224 even. I ain't lost a pound. I ain't scared to wear it. Listen to the book.
When the days of the siege are fulfilled.
When the days of the siege are fulfilled. Tell me what you want me to do.
And thou shalt take a third part and smite.
I ain't going to know a third part without measuring.
That's right.
Without knowing mathematics. You going to tell me we learning from these cave dwellers. I'll punch a nigga in the stomach.
That's right.
How that man going to know a third part? When we going to tell me we learn math from them? Being done stupid.
That's right.
Ain't build no pyramid and build that thing perfect sight without numbers and measurements.
That's right.
These folks ain't never taught no Mexican teach me how to build nothing.
That's right.
What I done, but we know.
That's right.
A coma donna tata. Can't teach us, man. They'll say all we did is take a read.
That's right.
Use a man to measure out.
That's right.
Try to measure the kingdom.
That's right.
Well, I'm going to wait till the white man gets a sucker because I don't know numbers. I's just a nigga. How you going to sit here and take a read and go measure out the kingdom?
Amen.
John gave you almost 1,800 miles in length.
Yeah.
For a city. How do you come up with that kind of quick measurement? He don't know mathematics.
That's right.
He knew man when he was in Egypt.
Yes, sir.
Noah had to build an ark. Right. Cubics. Right. You don't tell me these niggas ain't taught us no math.
That's right.
They around to build a little doing matchbox and you try to load all them animals in there. You got to know numbers. How you gonna count seven clean, two unclean? You don't know. Sir, I was a nigga. I asked to wait till America gets established. That's gonna teach me. Nigga, teach Toby how to count. What in the world are we gonna look like? How y'all done bought into these lies?
That's right. That's right.
How did Noah build an ark?
That's right.
Adam had to know numbers. How are we going to count days?
Yeah.
How Adam going to know the Sabbath?
That's right. That's right.
I got to know one to count to seven.
Yep.
Before they got him, why we let these people manipulate us so bad? Now we got to go to the university. They got to give you a piece of paper so you know how to count.
Mm.
Why have we let these people manipulate us so bad? And the problem I don't have with the natural education, I have a problem when it comes to being an offense against God's word. Please don't think it's an offense against a race. It's an offense, even if it's our people doing, when it gets us away from God's word. That's the detriment. We start to trust, and Jeremiah told the seventh child, I said, behold, these people trust in what, brother? That cannot what? Profit. Cannot profit. Now every great white hero, they come out, now they come out here to say they're black. I can't, they had to come, they showed a picture saying he had to be black. Christopher Columbus was black. And how you going to know when all the white folk get it, they're going to get rid of the day. Bang's going to be wide open. And no loan for color. That's when you're going to find out. They're going to cut your credit cards, all black people's credit cards be covered on Columbus Day. That's how you going to say, oh, y'all found out. John Hanson, they got two pictures of him.
Yep.
You can look up the white picture and they'll show he was black.
Yep.
A black man sat on a congressional Congress, president, not a United States. They didn't have a president of the United States. These people still stuck on kings and queens. They were still coming from this old bad doctrine they got from over in England. Look at that old fart they got in Elizabeth. Nobody pay her no attention. They don't even know where she got her money from. She ain't nothing about an old crack dealer.
That's right.
They've been dealing crack. Sit around one on somewhere, PSP is doing ridiculous. PCP, PSP, RSPC, all that stuff. Suck it to me. She know what I'm talking about.
That right?
Ain't that right? All of them getting high. Barbiturate. Oh, they been on it. Everyone they start. Everyone they cast up. Oh, so they been getting high.
Yep. That's right.
Oh, don't even know nothing about it. Yep. How you? Everybody, all of them ain't been nothing but some doing barbiturate use. Been on some pill junkies. Well, God gave up medicine. We got the tree, the leaves of the tree for the healing of the nation.
Yes, sir.
Our God supposed to be our healer.
Yes, sir.
Now we say these folk done got us so done domesticated and medicated. Mm. Once they medicated, domesticated
them.
Yep. Let me tell you just can't take down no Mendingo warrior like that. Ooh. First of all, you got to give them an illness. Then you got to tell them you got the cure for it.
Yeah.
Now you got it mind control.
That's right.
You can't say it, do so, mama. You got to go back and you got to get your medicine and your treatment from them.
That's right.
Listen, we've been knowing about medicine and operation. Let me tell you something. We were saying we were skilled surgeons.
Yeah.
We've been skilled surgeons. These folks ain't taught us nothing.
Yeah.
Doctors. How you think Isaiah knew how to go take fig leaves and heal King Hezekiah?
That's right. That's right.
You folks say it make no fool out of you. Just sit around, you just buy the hype of what people told. That's why you look so low on yourself. Because you don't know your God.
Yep.
So you try to put, I ain't putting nobody down. I'm saying let's just look at the truth.
Mm.
Explain me how we would count before we got here.
Right.
Solomon sitting here and told you, you don't count up to a darn thousand. Yeah. Count one by one.
That's right.
Those ain't taught me no sir. See, y'all didn't know basic, man. You're liars at one, two, three. Nigga, I done counted to a thousand.
That's right.
Then we ain't counted a thousand women.
Yep.
Saying more than four, count up to 300-400 and start it back over. One, two. Well, you can't stay consistent, man. I'm counting up to 2,000. And these folks make no darn fool out of you. Mm-hmm. Part of the hypocrisy of teaching you these lies to make you look more to your captives.
Mm-hmm.
Let me tell you something. Growing up, I tell you, I was a little boy, all I want to do is be white. Yo, well, clean. You ain't never want to be white. You ain't know no better. Just stop it. You'll be better. You sick. Anybody really grow up in black hard time, you want to be white. You wanted white privileges. You been to college. You want to be white. You know that right? You go to the university of the university. You want to be white. A lot of them might say, I don't want to be white. Why you want to live in better neighborhoods? Because they told you there's better things accessible to you in those neighborhoods. Because that's where white people live. Oh, a lot of people, they tell you, systematic, I can program it. You don't have to say everything with your mouth. Your behavior can demonstrate it.
Yeah, right.
Come on, y'all knew that.
Yep.
White is right, get back who? Get back black. They don't remember that's back for their time. Hey, you holler. Get back black. What's the bad ball to knock in? That A ball. Oh, white ball, you can get another shot. White ball going in the hole, you scratch. You put the ball back up. You can get a turn after this one. Knock that A ball. What happened to you? Game over. They already know when a nigga in the hole, game over.
Yeah.
White man, over how many of them played pool? That white ball going on how many times? You said, you get another turn.
Yeah.
It comes right back around, don't it? Get the ball back. You listen, you don't get another shot. I just got to go now. You go. You said, man, good thing you hit that black one in the hole. All this systematically trains you for something.
That's right.
Wow.
Yep.
Wow. What you think they do? When they gave you the black dog, look at how it look. Some of y'all favor that black dog in him. They listen. Where you think they got the privilege? Let me say, the black dog is not far off. Jet dog black. Ain't none of y'all have jet dog black. Red looking lip, eye look poked all out. The dog ain't that hair jets. Course, I mean the point is, look what did it say beside white, pretty, rosy cheek, long, luxurious hair. Ain't that right? Same side that white dog. They already showed you what a baby gonna do. Get that ugly black nigga dog out of the way and give him that pretty white one.
Yep.
It'll teach you. You don't think it didn't work? Most of our black women go to get what kind of hair?
White, blonde.
Blonde. Yep. Lighter color. They gonna put some color in their hair.
Yeah, right. That's right.
If they get the black hair, I don't want no cracker hair, no cracker blonde hair, man. They gonna go get some straight black hair. Because you do know crackers got black straight hair, too.
Yep.
Yeah, right.
Cracker is not a derogatory word. What does cracker mean, brother?
Crack the whip.
Crack the whip. See, you don't have a... The only people made up a derogatory word for white people were who? Amen. The Indian. He called him chicken mess.
Chicken dude.
Now, I wouldn't call him chicken mess. But everything you do basically socially puts you in that same mindset. That's why people look down at me and hate. Oh, you know why I use nigga? I'm not a sellout. I was a part of that. Don't use nigga. I was mad at our rappers. Our rappers trying to express themselves. I'm not justifying. They're trying to express themselves. When you encage a person and they don't know the truth, what you expect them to act like? Listen, I tell you, the most white, educated, richest man you got, let me put him in a cage and see how he act after a period of time.
Man,
let me lock him down and see what he act like. Let me sit him in here and don't give him a shade.
Yep.
Don't give him a bath. Let me take his suit, his iPad. Let me take his phone from his Samsung, his Apple phone from him. Let me take his custom-made shoes and suit and let me lock him in a cage. Let me beat him and call him a derogatory name. Let me sit and take his kids in their face and let me rape them. Let me hang him from a tree. Let me see how he acts. Let me see him walk out and use his education to survive. He'll become an animal.
Yep.
He'll become an animal.
Yep.
There are no race of people on this planet that have endured what we did and still bounced back.
That's right. That's right.
No race.
That's right.
Every one of the other races, they almost extinct.
Yep.
We still survive. There's no other race in the world. Look, they gave the Indian smallpox, they done their died.
Yep.
They gave us smallpox. You know, we made Tupac. We survivors.
Yep.
We took smallpox and made it rap.
That right.
No matter what you give us. You take instrument, we'll beat by. We'll do it with our mouth. We'll beat on our chest and on our leg. Ham bone. For these young folks, they don't know about that, do they?
That's right.
That stuff ain't nothing. All this stuff, that ain't creativity. We always had creativity.
That's right.
When you take from us, we gonna make.
That's right.
You take, we gonna make.
Yep.
I'm looking at a video they got somewhere over some part of Africa. Fella, all this stuff they doing, pole dropping, all these. They got this boy sitting here this high. This fella went back by right here. Run up here and drop that thing. Jump over and just clear it every time. I'm looking at the elders saying, what is, listen, no pool ball, none of that fooling. Listen, clear it every time. Don't do it one time, run back, hit it. Boom, listen, don't touch it one time. Pop over this thing. I said, that's what we do.
Yep.
We make our own way. See, one thing they done took from us is our survival skill, which is true. You can't survive without a God. The biggest crime ever committed in humanity, is taking away our God.
Yeah, you're right.
That's the only thing I fought this country for over anything else. When you took away our God, out of everything else you took from us, our kids, our wife, you bust up our marriage, you gave us drugs, you gave us cigarettes of a high content, you gave us alcohol, with more alcohol than any other beer, any other race drink. Yeah, I got to count you with more, the biggest crime ever. United Nations ought to be involved. Right now, ships, planes should be harboring their place right now, circuit to come and sit here and bring these people to trial.
That's
you
right.
Took out with God.
Yep.
I had a paper we put on our website to try to show people. Do y'all not know a lot of black congressmen and senators all got together and they wrote a letter up and they sent it and they trying to charge the United States? Y'all didn't even know that.
Yes, sir.
They don't even, listen, we have a copy of it. I'm talking about digitally mastered and composed and put together. And you know what one of the charges they charging America with? They're something. I'm talking about black senators and congressmen. They have written this up. We ain't talking about no little one page, little document showing. You know what they charging them for? Taking our religion. They know that they're nothing but slaves sitting on seats.
Yep.
And yet they can't say that. They have gotten together with an attorney and they have sent him and they are trying to get us to the United Nations and trying to get charges brought up on their plate. You wouldn't know nothing about it because you still watch a Queer Eye for the Straight Guy.
Yep.
They still got you in some fake reality television and of course the people on the family in the other room don't even know what's happening. Only you and millions of other people in here with the camera, the only one know what this child doing. The parents have no idea in the other room, and it was recorded a year and a half ago. And they were showing it before we ever published. What's finna happen? They programmed your mind. The only reason why I had to break off and have this talk, which I actually hadn't broken off, you just think I have, I got to tell you this because you're actually asleep.
Yeah.
You're in an unconscious state of who you are. You're in an unconscious state of there is a real God. And we got to stop accounting God to these trinkets they give us. These pieces of material they put on. This ain't a God. They got that and they have no God.
Right.
You have to be a spiritless and a godless individual to do some of the crime these people create and have done. Mm-hmm. And still set up. They have no caring. Mm-hmm. Has no bearing. They'll fight for laws that make no sense that they themselves supposedly don't even do. I'm not homosexual. I just think two men ought to be able to get married. Sure, I'm not homosexual. Mm-hmm. Sure, I'm not homosexual, I'm for the family. All their acts are coming back to prove them out. And the sad part is, the reason why we're attached, because you live a lie too. You're a liar yourself. You know you yourself got another life. So it ain't hard for you to sit around and adjust to these people's system and don't see nothing wrong with it. Because you've been hypocriting all your life. They program us in what they call churches. They teach us. As long as you want to do better, you don't actually have to. When a man or woman chewing their husband and wife and they get caught, I really didn't want to do it. I didn't mean to do it. I'm sorry. Sure you did. If you really didn't want to do something, why did you do it?
That's right.
Why did you do it? Because this is the problem I would have. My wife cheated on me. I'm able to not. I know we got people did this thing. And she really didn't want to do it. I would expect the best. She told me, well, that's what I want to do. Because she told me she really didn't want to do it. She never meant for it to happen. She didn't want to do it. She tried everything not to do it. She still did it. I have a nigga with no self-control. Why would I keep you? What's going to stop you from doing it again? After all, you've already been through that. You really didn't want to do it. You tried everything not to do it. It just happened. What's to stop it from happening again? Even in the prison system, the purpose of when they put a person in is called the rehabilitated person. They don't find you being when they bring you to parole is to sit down and people to question you to see, do you show any type of characteristics? Do you show any type of conformity going back to your old self? What's your plans when you get out? All these things are to check you to see, are you safe or sufficient to put you back in society? And we do nothing. We sit around, we dwell among people. Have we actually sat down and checked these people out that we're dwelling with? Have we checked these people to see if it was informing or conforming them going back? You got to ask yourself. When I can see a 20, I went on vacation. I seen about a 20, probably between 20, 24-year-old Caucasian male with a big old Dixie shirt on. What could make a 20 to 23-year-old boy put on a Big Dixie flag who would have never been allowed to know anything about what had happened now? Who could only seen film strips or looked at books? It's in your behavior.
Yep.
You've been taught. It's in your gene pattern. That's what they told you.
Yep.
When you locked up and they sat on the exam in your court, they're going to tell you the first thing they want to find was her father in the home. What about your mother? Did she ever molest you? Mm-hmm. They start looking at characteristics, and you don't. Unfortunately, you don't. You don't see yourself going right back into degradation where you came out because you don't think. He programmed your mind and said, that's just one. That's just one that you see. That's a whole lot more that think like you do. People don't like dealing with reality. That's why I don't blame people. I don't like Tony Smith either. I hate that nigga. He don't be talking about nothing. He teach hate. I teach hate sin. I teach love God and love and respect yourself. And the only way to actually do that is to know God. That's why we got to be taught. The reason why I had to talk about these other things, you got to see where your transgression. That's what he told Isaiah to do, cry, spell, lift up your voice, and shoot my people and the house of Jacob. It's hard to see God when you got all these systematic things working around you. There's too many other avenues they give you for employment, too many other helps they give you. Our whole help used to come from God. Y'all remember back in, I can tell you what year you grew up, 50s? Somewhere now? Sir? In the 40s? We grew up, mother. 50s. They had employment agents to help y'all get jobs. You got to just get out and get it for yourself. Now we got to go here and we fill out a card or paper and I'll get back with you. Which means now you sit and you do nothing till I get back to you. You still a slave. You sit and you wait. What did I tell you? Didn't I say I'm going to call you when I find something? You ain't got a mind of your own. Had no survival skill. We lost it. We got their God. We're atheists at heart. We'll say we're not. You're atheists at heart. Because you actually believe God, you'll do differently. David in the 14th division of Psalms said, a fool have said out of his mouth,
heart.
There is no what?
God.
If you actually believe it was a God, there will be a different action from you.
Mm-hmm.
See, everything don't have to be said with your mouth. It can be said through your actions. See, I like it this way, the way it got it. If you look at me now, I'm one of the dumbest, most illiterate niggas you're going to ever see in your life. I'm a joke if you really watch a little. I don't know what I'm doing up here. I'm not even a preacher. Hadn't even been to seminary school. I ought to be ashamed of myself. These people have never certified me or classified me to do my job. I dare me. They have the license stamp, and they got to officiate, and they got to certify anything you do in order for it to be right. Can't be right no other way. How do we function before they certify or officiate anything
we've
ever done?
That's right.
When Paul talked about presenting our body as a living Kodesh,
acceptable.
Unto who now?
God.
Which is your what? You know where our fault always been? We've done everything to appease our master to try to get them to like us. Truth be told, that's why I dress like that. Because now when he see me walking down the street, he don't run from me. Get his kid. Come on. This a nigga. He see me now, he say, that nigga all right. He been tamed. Oh, they do. Come on now. I let them pants dry. They been get that stomach hair come out of like this right here. That nigga crazy. Do you not know, most of y'all, how many of y'all know about dogs? Dogs give signs. When a dog come, his tail ain't wagging, he's not coming to be your friend. His tail not wagging, he's not coming to be your friend. Certain things you watch for aggression. And now he trained you just like a dog. He know he's broken our aggression. Not our aggression to fight against him, but our aggression to try to fight for survival to become a better people. He broke it. When he feels, he see your tail wagging. He see you control. He take everyone out hard rapper. Oh, they all come up. Oh, Gangsta Rapper Craig. Now they get Gangsta Rapper Craig. They get him say, you know what? We see some moves we can put you in. Oh, F the police for that. Break all. I'm burning. Kill. I break out of prison. They come along. Kids, don't do drugs. Kids, love the police. Kids, do whatever white people tell you to do. Make them cut it, have domestic. But they just show you. Listen. This is not the first time to sit. Let me tell you something. The CIA used mind-altering drugs on the military first.
Yep.
Y'all didn't know. That's how LSD got out.
Right.
Y'all remember that years ago, LSD? The CIA used it on the military first. mile to put them in a crisis situation, set them down, give it to them. Let them hear a play and let them just crack up and just watch them, just film them, just watch the mind. They've been using mind altering drug to see how to control people. You take a trained soldier, discipline, show him something, then give him a drug and see how you can break him down and reduce him down to rubbles. Now he come along, now he put it out here in fight and he put it on us. Biggest drug he get us with is the media. Music and television kill a nigga.
Yep.
I teach you when I want you to go act and react and when to kill each other. I tell you when crime, listen, he been practicing. When he came out with the terror, listen, he gave you colors. Orange, highest level, and red. That means terror, something happening. I watch you niggas panic. I watch you dead say, but the level down, we got it.
That's right.
Go back up a little bit, make you panic and what? I can watch you.
Yeah.
Mind altering, through television, through communication, through your phones. I get your phone through data, shoot you information, tell you something happening that's actually not happening. I show you what, I get you ready, get you winning. Then you say, oh, didn't that happen? I control the minds of some. They did it, though they move when I tell them. We are supposed to be a people controlled by God. I'm not telling you to ignore the what. I'm telling you to look at the signs. The signs that God is trying to bring us back to being a respected people.
Amen.
And the only way to do that is to break us down. The only way to do it is to break us back down. See, when Israel got into captivity, guess what they wound up recognizing? Then they called on God. He said, when I afflicted them, then they sought me. Even when he put the son on the cross, what did he say? Children, have you any meat? What did he say? My God, why hast thou forsaken me? When he was afflicted, the Lord saw when you put a man in affliction, then he got to seek something greater than himself.
Mm-hmm.
Right now, you don't see nothing greater than you in the system. That's why you won't turn to God.
Yeah.
Now, God got to come along and break the system so now you can turn to God, which in turn means I got to break you.
Yeah.
If I had some education and some knowledge, I could talk to people and get them to take a different light on their stand.
Yeah, right.
But unfortunately, being a retard, I can't do it.
Yeah, right.
People won't listen. I couldn't tell people anything that's valuable to them. And you don't see it affects you in your servitude toward God. It affects you when you hear the word. You keep trying to rationalize wrong. That's why you can sit in bad relationships and you can sit around and let people do things to you because systematically it's been done to you all your life.
Mm-hmm.
That's the woman with a man hit her. She can tell you it ain't all the time. There's always justification. See, when you got a person that ain't never been loved and never understood love, any form of anything is love. Whatever you can get, you just learn to make the best out of it. And that's sad for us. The best for us is nothing less than God. That's the best we got. You got to give me God. Everything else is invaluable to me. It's not a real profit. It's only temporary. I got to see God. You actually working without a mission, because if you're not working, if you're not saving, not working towards salvation, what are you actually working for? At the end of your life, what is it you look to achieve? Retirement? That's not, you still got death. What are you looking at? Extra income? What are you working for? You still got to attach death to the end of whatever you're doing in this natural world. What are you trying to achieve? And who are you trying to see? See my dead mother. Key word, dead. I'm dead, see my dead mother. What are we both going to be?
Dead.
I got to have some type of understanding. I'm trying to get some type of gravitating to something that's bigger than or something after death. I'm looking to see somebody living, which means I got to see God, which means I got to learn how to find God. I got to learn how to identify God. What does God require and what's the requirement in order to see God at the end of days? That's why we're here. All these people taught us and all they got us working for is you're in a rat race. It's an illusion. It's an illusion. How many of y'all ever got this before in your life? Ain't got to be this number. Sister Lincoln, it could be $1, it could be $100, it could be $1,000. How many of y'all got this before in your life? How many of you have been given gold? Not a necklace. Because your necklace has not had pure gold. Your necklace has had more, it had a portion of gold and it's had more metal in it than gold. How many of you have ever been given gold and this was taken back? I give you this. I'm going to get this back now. Don't lose your darn mind now. Hold it right there. Hold it up there. I know y'all niggas. Y'all got all kind of tricks you can put in this. But now, I'm giving you this to pay for a debt. A promissory note that I'm going to give you 20 or the equivalent of what this paper says in gold. Has anybody ever received that? So you received it in gold. Somebody gave it to you that weight in gold. One man. For what? A 10, a 20, a 100? Huh? Okay, it wasn't a what? How much? Few ounces? For how much it is? Let me ask you this now. Somebody gave you this piece of paper, and they came back and got that paper back and gave you the gold in value. That's what I'm talking about. So every time you got this, you've never been paid.
Right.
You know people sitting in prison that kill people for this?
Yep.
Never been paid. See, this whole country built on this. Come on now. I threw a bunch of these up in the room. What y'all finna do?
Go crazy.
Nigga finna lose their mind. For a bunch of promises.
Yep.
Not the gold, for the promises. We go to banks and we get them back the promise, and we get them another piece of paper written from a jar that said, get them, nigga, another promise.
Mm-hmm.
We all shooting broken promises around here.
Right.
Nobody ever been paid.
That's right.
You see the illusion? We'll kill somebody for this. For a promise that's never been paid. China has come over here and tried to get these people to show them not the promise, they want to see the gold. Because they said, we got too many of these and you have nothing to back them with. So in the international market, you can't play this game. They need the gold move, not this. You can go on a roll and print. That's why they want to stop you from printing it. Calling you a counterfeiter. That's what they are. They never gave you the equivalent to this.
That's right.
Don't tell me about no big. You know any counterfeiter? Yeah. The U.S. government.
That's right.
Because you've never been. But see, this is part of the illusion of why people don't look for God. I give you a whole bunch of broken promises. And in your mind, you think they're asking me, oh, I let you get stuff. Everything you get with this, you never own. How many of y'all paid your house off? How many of y'all own your home? You own your home paid for free? Well, you don't own it. And when you pay it off, you don't own it. Because
right.
You still pay taxes.
Right.
You still going to control. Because it don't make sense to let you own it. Because this is not actually buying nothing. This is on a promise.
Right.
This is an agreement to give you something with this, and it's never been given. So all we're doing is swapping lies. I swap a lie to make you think you own something that you can't possibly own because you never paid for it. The people who gave you the loan just gave me a bunch of these saying you're going to pay me. They ain't never been paid. Yep. So I got to keep another tag. Even your car, you're going to keep buying tags or something. Yep. Everything you give them, I always keep something over you because everything is an illusion. The only thing that's truth is God. And until you see that, you're going to continue to live your life like a fool. You work to fight and kill for paper. Before I try to book a chain right quick, I'm going to try to let y'all go. Please don't think I done ran out because I went off on this. Fourth chapter of the book of James. At verse 1. Listen to the book.
From whence come wars?
That's why I want to. Where wars come from? Where else?
And fightings among you.
And fighting among you.
Come they not hence, even of your lust that war in your members?
Listen.
Ye lust and have not. Ye kill and desire to have and cannot obtain. Ye fight and war, yet ye have not, because ye ask not. Ye ask and receive not. Because you ask amiss.
How do you ask? What's amiss, brother? You do it wrong. It's wrong. Nobody never told us that. Conditioning mind. God don't have a problem with us having things. God have a problem when things have us. That's our biggest failure. I get $1 million first thing I'm doing, buy my mama a house. I'm going to do this. All this stuff is wrong. $1 million is not our problem. Getting money, getting wealth is not our problem. Our problem is getting God. We're creative people. We're talented people. We're proficient people. There's a lot of things we can do except for being able to get God. Take a teacher. What the teacher tells us to do, we can't do because we got too many things going on inside our mortal bodies. Our carnal mind been overtaken and been invaded by the system. They know you invaded. See, every other country, we heard for years, America, the best place in the world. You were to live in these other countries. You don't have rights and things. You can't do stuff. You saw these other people uprising their countries. They don't like the government. They're doing what our Constitution said we're supposed to do. When the people don't like the government, then the people should take the government down and establish a new what now? Egypt showed us. Egypt didn't like the government. They got Mubarak down. They put another one up. They didn't like that government. They took it down again. You know, we say, well, we changed it one time. They used to change it again. They look at changing until they find one that suit the people. Iraq doing it. You know, the people that fight just like Afghanistan going to do when they get out. They looking at this. That's not our government. That's the government you set up. Not us. We come over here, these niggas. This is our government. These people are more freer thinkers than we are. These people look at things based around their religion and their religious belief. They'll die for it. They'll kill people for what it is they believe. I'm not telling you to kill anybody, but you got to be willing to die for what you believe. If you say you believe in God, will you die for it? Are you willing to hold to it even because you poverty or job loss? Even because of affliction or problem with your family? Do you really believe it? See, a lot of people don't believe a lot of things. You say you do, but you really don't believe it. They got to get to a point, it's embarrassing to watch all these other people. You watching people in Thailand upright. You watching people in China upright. China government don't play. Yet you got people willing to die. They got a famous film strip 20 years ago, a man standing in front of a tank. In front of a tank and make the tank turn. He knows the tank can blow him up a gun. He knows the tank can kill him. But he said, but what I believe. What I believe I can make this tank turn. What do you really believe? I believe in what I'm doing. That's why I'm here. I'm fighting against a system that's almost impossible and virtually beat by human factors, not by God factor. Take a man and stand on what he really believes. These people would love to be able to discredit me. They'll love for me to say, well, just one of these nice sisters to him. They'll love one of these little kids to get naked in my lap and get me on some porn film with them. They'll love to catch me at a nightclub or with some marijuana. They'll love to do it. So they can discredit me and then they can say, see, ain't no God. Trust the system. Go with who the system support. T.D. Jake, Juanita Bynum. Well, she just a hooker black hole. Don't even count on her no more. She broke hole now. T.D. Jake, Eddie Long, Creflo Dollar. What's the man with the dead, with the squirrel on his head? All these people are CIA operatives. I've been telling y'all that. Al Sharpton, Jesse Jack, they're CIA operatives. The CIA has always given us our so-called Negro leaders. They tell you who to believe, who to worship, then they take them down. It's just part of the system, then they put them back up. That's how they do it. That's how they program it. They use it for when it's convenient for them and make you think you're going to help your people. That's what they did when the Atlanta kid murders came through. Blacks were going to arrive, and blacks were going to take Atlanta down, burn it to the ground. Our kids were being murdered. Massacre. Y'all remember that, don't you? They put a Negro up and told us, calm. That's how we got to do it, with calm. When Susan Smith drowned her own two little white babies, is that what they used in South Carolina? Calm? Solace? Let's let the law work. White people took it upon themselves to snatch blacks off the street. They didn't tell you they did it. Any and every black man they could get their hands on, they snatched them off. You remember that in South Carolina? They ain't talk about that, did they? Why they ain't use the restraint they wanted Atlanta to use? I mean, I don't know why niggas couldn't control themselves. They were just having their kids kidnapped and their penises cut off and put in their mouth and throw it in a lake. I don't know why we couldn't control ourselves. Why we couldn't get some calm. Just let the system work. Why don't we want to act a fool when the GBI had a tape of the white man that recorded himself and he said he destroyed it? Because if it had came out, it would have been a mess. Why black folk want to act like a nigga and not let the system work? That's how it is. That's how it is. They program you to be. Now they know they got these churches that get you on a fake God. They tell you he going to do it. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about nothing. Well, you know what? The church got to get raised some money. We ain't got to raise no money. Let God pay for it. God going to go out here and do all this other stuff. Won't God just pay the bill?
Right.
See, y'all niggas losing your mind now. No, you got to give the money. God do the other stuff. That's how you make a fool. That's how you do with your government when you pay taxes. Taxes is an illusion. Taxes were only implemented for the war. That's how he programmed. He started the war, got you thinking you were supporting your country, helped them. Then when you came back from the war, he told you, let's just keep the system rolling. And you know what? Another program he used to teach you the same thing, toll rolls. They come out and get you niggas at the schools, and we need to put better roads in. What we're going to do is put a toll road up. Niggas, y'all pay 25 cents for 2 years. Take that 2, put a 0 behind it, it'd be 20.
Yep.
See, once I get you started, they learn a nigga won't stop. All you got to do is get him started. He'll get stuck with that premise. He'll never break himself free. He'll never question or buck the system. That's what we got to stop doing. You got to start questioning the system. Now, what I'm saying to get you killed. Make no mistake, they watching me. Now, make no mistake, they wouldn't dare use a white man to kill me. Be too obvious. That'd be my claim to fame. Why'd it take me down? I'd be a superstar. You got to use a nigga.
Yep.
Nobody sell out like a nigga.
Mm-hmm.
When they needed riots started, when Dr. King was marching, they used niggas. Your FBI Cowley went to black kids and got them to incite riots. They've always done it. It's part of propaganda. Put them up, then break them down, then you sell, and you make them a big star for the people. But I'm not going to sit and bow down to the system. I've done it almost all my life, as some of you are still doing today. That's why it's hard for you to kind of hear what I'm saying. That's why you had to daydream and do other stuff. Because you're not a part of the fixing the problem. You're a part of the problem. Because you can't be a free thinker. You can't sit around and see other than what they tell you and what they program you. Everything he tell you, you got to look past it. You got to look further into it. When he come give you something, you better watch why he get. Ask the Indian when they left, when they got put out the reservation. You going to look like you cold, Injun. You know I hate y'all red niggas. Get this blanket so you don't freeze out there and something happened to you and your kid. What I just gave him?
Smallpox.
How you got it? Because he going to wrap his baby up with it. He ain't going to blame that on me, is he? I'm going to tell you right now. Well, this red boy here for the blankets on me. No, you need to be vaccinated. Now he need to come see me so I can give him shots. These shots going to stop him from his kids from dying. Look at how many of our kids come up with these diseases. They weaken our immune system. They know the biggest way to beat us is to get us weak. They've broken us down through medication. They broke us down through hospitalization. They broke us down through education. We've already defeated. Listen, when you can beat a man with no guns and no knives, I beat you through teaching you. He beat us through help. Listen, I got a system. If you married, y'all married. Y'all are married, just trying to help y'all. Like if one of y'all won't work, y'all need help. My system can help y'all out. Yeah, I got a system to help out. Y'all like grocery? Y'all do? Y'all like to eat and stuff like that? Like to be able to go, you like to be able to go to grocery store and get what y'all want? Y'all do? You like to have money in your pocket and get a steady check. Would y'all like a steady check coming every month? Sure. Steady check. I'm gonna need you to get him out. Then I'm going to give you, think about it for the kids. I'm going to give you food every month, and I'm going to give you a check. It's just going to make sense for him to be gone. I just destroyed the home. His help has been the worst help we ever got in our life. Some help is better. Sometimes you see a ride come by, it ain't really a ride. It's more of a bird. I need a ride. Hey, let me get it. Come on, man, jump on the back and push the car. This ain't no ride. How that's a ride? I'm pushing the car. But a nigga's been a ride all this time. That ride always costs you something. Next time for our eyes to come illuminated and realize the only one that's ever been in our favor, the Negro, has been one of our worst helpers as well. Only one ever been in our favor had been God. Only one to come along to reestablish us and put the family back together where it's supposed to be functioning, it's been God. Nobody come along and talk to man how to be a man. They taught him how to look better, look like Billy D. Williams. What was Billy D. Williams looking like back then? Denzel. Come on, they programmer. Who the women love? Chestnut been Denzel. What Denzel, how his marriage is? Let me cheat with Sanaa Lathan. These women, they'll fight for him. Oh, you go cheat with Sanaa Lathan. See if your wife let you stay there. Y'all leave Denzel alone. They program your mind. You know when women lost, when you really lost a lot of your integrity back in the 90s? When Bill Clinton had sex with Monica Lewis and you weren't worried about that. You worry about the country being ran. You ain't looking at his morality level.
Mm-hmm.
So you sign off on so much bad stuff that you know what? These folks come on, they programmed your mind. As long as a woman get there, tell him, man, I don't care what he do, nigga, as long as he pay the bills. You just set him up to be insufficient. See, in order to be a man, you can't just pay the bills. You got to make sure you take care. That home got to have more than just money and a figure there. That home got to have some understanding. There's a caring that has to come from a man. A man can't learn to be a man without another man teaching him, instructing him, and showing him. How are women gonna go out and get a good man when she hadn't seen one? Long as he come home, pay the bill, he can go to sleep and don't be functional, he gonna be a problem. He gonna be a problem. How many of them ever said, at least I'm here? But if you're not functioning, you're not here. Just like we do when we sit in this synagogue. You here, but you're not functioning. Because you're not actually following, obeying. We got to be the provider. We got to be the image. We got to be the factors in our homes. Our boys ain't got no better looking to no Beyonce. Mother, you got to go back and show him character and what a real woman does and how a real woman carries herself. We've lost it. Of course they'll let us get them. But whites are trying to get dignity back. Well, you know what? It don't hurt them to have what the little crazy girls say that time she was with that little bottle head. Lady Gaga. Lady Gagging. Whatever her name is. She don't hurt them. Listen, they have enough good, clean, white images to get theirs back on point. They know they're going to lose some. You'll have just as many blacks that'll listen to her than whites. The biggest way to take a nigga down and let them see somebody white, they say, anybody white go? They say, yes, sir. I'm going that way then. Got him. Got him. Come on, the military do that. Listen, the military learn sometime to get what you want, you got to sacrifice some of your, well, I heard this wild fictitious animation war called Pearl something. Harbor. Why am I at Pearl Harbor? The Japs wind up blowing up Pearl Harbor. That the United States government set up. Use them for targets. Soldiers that had no idea or no knowledge, just sitting here doing their job on the base, set them up and let the job blow it up so they can have a right to go get in the war.
That right.
If I had some education, do y'all know I would know this kind of stuff? But being dumb and uneducated, I have no idea about any of this stuff.
Right.
I just had to wait till it come on TV. If Fred Sanford and them don't show up, I'm in trouble. But it just shows you the expense these people will go through just to get a point across. They care nothing about white life. What make you think they care about you? We have to be our own producers. We have to take care of ourselves. We have to get back to our God. That's been our problem. Finish me in the third chapter of the book of Zephaniah. I try to let y'all go. I'm through talking. Let me stop it. I went over my limit. Talking about stuff I ain't got no business. I don't even know about that kind of stuff. What folk told her all that? Quit talking about stuff you don't know about.
That right.
Dumb me. That's what happens when you don't get no education. You start talking about stuff you don't even know nothing about. This is the third chapter of the book of Zephaniah, verse 1. Listen to the book.
Woe to her that is filthy. And
which is what, brethren? Rebellious. Your rebellion has come up to be your filth. Your rebellion has come up to be your shame. We rebelled against our God. Our women are whores. Our men are insufficient. Our kids not obeying their parents. Who do you think he's talking about? All we need is a good spiritual black Negro leader. They can take us up to Washington, D.C., and we can stand in front of Lincoln Center.
That's right.
Man, if I can just get a million of y'all niggas, and we can get $1 from a million of y'all, I can come back and fix our communities. Hotels raping us.
Yep.
Airfare, transit, gas company are raping us.
Yep.
Restaurants raping us, and they know a nigga ain't finna do nothing.
Yep.
First place it started, you want to make a change in your home.
That's right.
That's where it started. Let's get to the root of the problem. Let my kids see me love my own wife. Let me take time out to sit down and talk to them and enlighten them. Let me show them instead of just telling them. They got to see something different here. And we're going to make a real... Going to Washington, D.C., most of them ain't going to catch it. Too many video games going to take up their time. It's summertime. I got time to watch that God. They got to see action done here. Listen.
Woe to her that is filthy and polluted.
Come on, son.
To the oppressing city.
Yeah.
She obeyed not the voice.
That's us. We don't obey the voice. Come on, son.
She received not correction.
We won't take no correction. Listen.
She trusted not in the Lord.
Y'all hear that? We won't trust in God. Come on.
She drew not near to her God.
Listen.
Her princes within her are roaring lions.
Doing what?
Her judges are evening wolves.
Doing what?
They gnaw not the bones till tomorrow.
They won't wait till tomorrow. They devour everything today. We ain't got no reason. We ain't got no reason, no mind to set up for tomorrow. We got a system that take care of us. We lose our job, we go to the system. We need something, you need something, go to the system. Why would you? We don't have no self-preservation. We can't set ourselves up for no future because we already got a system that take care of us. That's what the system for. Too dumb to get health care, he got to come give it to us. He got to tell us what kind of get, make us sound and do something we were too irresponsible to do for ourselves. Then he give us government health care. Insufficient health care. So now he can program you and he can immunize you. It's all to control your mind. It's mind altering everything he give you. Listen.
Her prophets are light and treacherous persons.
Come on, son.
Her priests have polluted the sanctuary.
Y'all hear that? That's why they let everything in. Long-haired men, bald-headed women, women with pants on, lipstick, earring, crosses on. He's like, what he say polluted? Because the priest should do what?
Acknowledge.
And the people should hear the law well.
Amen.
When the law go against it, why the man won't stop and tell the folk it's unacceptable inside God's house?
That's right.
Because we got to draw people. In order to draw people, you can't talk about everything wrong. Tell the people something good. Okay, it's good for you going to hell if you don't do it.
That's right.
Where are the men that are supposed to teach the law? Why ain't somebody, a woman sitting in the front seat, we got to go bring our towel to cover up her legs? Vagina all our fish air with cats scratching the windows and doors. Instead of putting the door in stand, I tell her, no, you're insufficient. Put some darn clothes on yourself. You ain't gonna hear God's word like that. Where the standard at? Come on.
Her priests have polluted the sanctuary. They have done violence to the law.
Damage. You ain't got no bed now. Where's in the Bible women can't wear pants? Where is that? God ain't looking at that. Sure he not. When you a diamond. We were clearly taught that the pants were given to the priest and to their son, breeches. They were never given to the woman. They were given to the man. Listen.
The just Lord is in the midst thereof.
And he will do what?
He will not do iniquity.
He's not going to commit no sin. Come on.
Every morning doth he bring his judgment to light.
Come on.
He faileth not, but the unjust knoweth no shame.
Y'all hear that? That's the sad part. You got people sitting here. Y'all can smoke. Y'all can drink. Y'all can homebunk. You can lie. You can cheat. You can steal. Not pay your tithe because you're unjust. You don't know no shame. That's dangerous. That's dangerous. I have shame. You know I've been baptized up here. No, there's some woman, some gay guy that waiting to come out here and bust me up. My gay lover. My instrument. I have. Do y'all know how to just burn in hell for that? How many preachers have done that? I just burn in hell right immediately. I shouldn't even wait for no. Best burn in hell. I don't even know. Where's your shame at for what you do?
That's right.
It does anybody feel God?
Yep.
It's just like Isaiah said, they are not all obeyed.
Yep.
Y'all ain't all obeyed. It's dangerous. Listen.
I have cut off the nations. Their towers are desolate.
Come on.
I made their streets waste.
Come on.
That none passeth by.
Come on.
Their cities are destroyed.
Mm-hmm.
So that there is no man.
Come on.
That there is none inhabited.
We know about that, don't we? What was he looking for? To do what?
Stand
to stand where? For the what? For the land that I should not destroy. But didn't find none. Come on, son.
I said, surely that would fear me.
You hear that? I said, surely people would fear me. Come on.
Thou will receive instruction.
You will receive instruction.
So their dwelling should not be cut off.
See, that was Jeremiah was trying to tell about the Sabbath, wasn't it? Bring no burdens in on the Sabbath. Do none of these things. What other prophet? What other prophet governor came up trying to talk about the Sabbath? Nehemiah. Told the people to make a covenant on the Sabbath. They didn't buy no victual from these people. That these people to do nothing. Where y'all think he got it from? Even Daniel told you he understood by the year, by the books, according to who?
Jeremiah.
Jeremiah the prophet, that they were going to accomplish 70 years in the desolation. It's all over the Sabbath, and yet we come along there and we infringe the Sabbath now. Come on.
Howsoever, I punished them.
No matter how I punished them, what they do, son?
But they rose early and corrupted all their doings.
Soon as I got finished with these people chastising, God said, went right back to what they were doing. Every time we come along, he give us another oppression by these people. It don't make no difference. Soon we get out, ain't gonna let nobody turn me around. Nigga singing, turn me around, turn me around. Ain't gonna let nobody turn me around. Keep on walking. Keep on talking, walk on to freedom and land, oh nigga. That's your problem. Somebody need to turn you around, get on the pathway to God.
That's right.
Nigga, spiritual done messed us up.
Yep.
They ain't lie though. Didn't nobody turn around. Mm-hmm. No matter how severe God said I chastise him, you still wouldn't stop. Them niggas right. Sung the truth.
Yep.
Listen.
Therefore, wait ye upon me, saith the Lord.
Why?
Until the day that I rise up to the prey.
Yeah. Come on.
For my determination is to gather the nations.
Y'all hear that? That's he said, my determination. He said, wait for me that I rise up to pray. Mm. Who y'all think he talking about?
Judah.
Who?
Yeshua.
Judah. He said, Judah, thou art a lion's whelp.
Yep.
Say, Jah, he rose up to the prey. Now, a lion ears come up when they start seeing prey coming. They say it's a chance for a hunt, everything changed. He said, therefore wait for me till I rise up. He just told you about Judah. Judah wasn't going to jump up and do this. Yep. We're going to tie right back to Yeshua. He said, wait for me till I rise up to the prey. Listen.
That I may assemble the kingdom.
That's his determination. He's going to assemble all these kingdoms together. Listen.
To pour upon them my indignation.
Because God going to put all his indignation on them. Come on.
Even all my fierce anger.
All my fierce anger.
For all the earth shall be devoured with the fire of my jealousy.
Y'all hear that, don't you? Come on, son. This is what he want
to
do.
For then will I turn to the people.
But this is what he said. Then, what are you going to do, brother?
What?
I'm going to return to the people.
At pure language.
You hear that? God's going to put us back to where we at. He's going to put us back to a better state. After our destruction. After God come down and rain down destruction on Jerusalem again. His determination to get us back. It's going to be vengeance on their people. That's the book of Luke. He said, there's going to be the days of vengeance upon this people. When God said, when I come up to rise up to pray and I pour my indignation on their people, then he's going to return to you a pure language.
Yes, sir.
This is what else he's going to leave, son.
That they may all call upon the name of the Lord.
With what?
To serve him with one consent.
Why are these folks trying to come along and try to teach us not everybody Hebrew? The Lord said he come back and put this story. He's going to pull us all back to one language. Nehemiah slapped us around. That didn't change nothing.
Nope.
God said he'd come back and he put the affliction on us. I'm going to return back to people of pure language. Listen.
From beyond the rivers of Ethiopia, my suppliants.
What that? What is my supplanter? What that? My worshipers. We've been dispersed into Ethiopia. Ethiopians are not Jews. We got Jews that have been dispersed into Ethiopia. When Ezekiel took the hay, put in the hay, he told us, let the wind blow it. Who fed is in his hand.
That's right.
Our people been dispersed and scattered all over that place. He ain't no more go past Ethiopia, my worshipers. Listen.
Even the daughter of my dispersed.
Even the daughters of my dispersed. What you looking to do, Lord?
Shall bring mine offering.
Listen, how they going to bring my offering?
In that day shalt thou not be ashamed for all thy doings.
Yes.
Wherein thou hast transgressed against me.
Listen.
For then I will take away out of the midst of thee them that rejoice in thy pride.
Yes.
And thou shalt no more be haughty because of my Kadesh mountain.
Y'all hear that? Jerusalem made us haughty at one time.
Amen.
We thought we were better than people because we sat in that land.
Yeah.
Moses tried to tell them when he got ready, the Lord was going to go and pull us out. He said, the Lord didn't draw these people out because of your righteousness. It's because the other people were so wicked. Moses was clear in telling us before we even got into it, said the Lord was going to bring them in the land. He said, I don't want y'all to go ahead and thinking the Lord, you going to start lying, telling the Lord drove those people out because of your righteousness. He said, that is not why. It's because they were so wicked. Listen.
I will also leave in the midst of thee.
A what?
An afflicted and poor people.
He was going to leave a humble people. See, when the Lord rained down his destruction on us in our land, Jerusalem, because we got to be chastised for what we've done. Judah got to pay. Israel got out of their land. As it is today, they're not inheriting no Samaritan, even to this day. And God's going to get us, he's going to bring us right on back over there. And y'all already know what's going to happen. God's going to rain down destruction on them when he get through, because he's going to break down and get the haughty from among us. He's going to get them that rejoice and they hide themselves because they think Jerusalem is our homeland. They ain't going to be enough to save you. God going to break us down. He going to get him a people out of the midst of the people. Just like with Judah. Judah was one time with Israel. We were one people. God got him a people out of the midst of the people. And he going to do it again. And he going to leave us unafflicted. That's going to be a humble people. When you're behind getting whipped, you getting beat, your pride broke. Right now you got too much pride. It's hard for y'all to turn to God. But it's God's determination to gather the nation and give us back one language. And in leaving us an afflicted.
And a humble and poor people.
And a poor people. Come on.
And they shall trust in the name of the Lord.
That's what's going to do it. Hard to trust God. Now we got too much government assistance. Nobody need no God. That's just be praying. You need no God. You got agencies you can call to pay your rent now. And you know you got behind. It's places you can call. Who need a God when you got a place you can call and get assistance to pay your rent? Next week, them people have a check cut. All they have to do is call the bank. You got a place you can send your bills and they'll give you money. Who need a God? Years ago, we had to pray to God. We couldn't pay bills. We couldn't make it. We didn't have a meal. We got agency to take care of that now. But God said, when I come back and I get you, I'm going to leave you all afflicted and a poor people. And that's a good thing. Blessed are the poor. That's what Jesus told you. That's going to be a blessing. But they're going to be the kingdom of heaven. That's good, brother. Thank the Lord.